Get ready to fall in love. It's be cruel to me. No, it's be cruel to me.
Me.
No, you know, give me it all. What do I need to do to please you? Make me a brown. Round like a hole. It's so humiliating. Choke me. Choke me. Oh, I felt that in my ass. It's be cruel to me. It's be cruel to me. No, it's be cruel to me.
Me.
I didn't believe in me. This is a lot to take in. Calling you out. Don't fuck me unless you're angry. I love that. Call me. Even when no one is watching. Choke me. Oh, I felt that in my ass. It's be cruel to me. It's be cruel to me. No, it's be cruel to me.
Me.
Cecil's sexiest second move is excruciating. Oh, did he say his sexiest move? It's called a Vaseline power punch. I don't know. I applaud him. What he do is a little bit of grab ass. Second move. Choke me. Choke me. I felt that in my ass. It's be cruel to me. It's be cruel to me.
Me.
Bobby, I want you to meet my colleague, Dr. Hamilton.
And I'd like you to get the fuck out of here.
Oh, it's all
right. Get out of here.
It's prime.
Dude, my StreamYard's been janky since last week.
What was it not supposed to do that?
No. Like it presses a button, it starts it, and then stops. We were supposed to be behind there, but. Yeah,
it looks like there's two intros. Well, dude, it's a good way to start the show. Everybody likes it when they see the film flub. You know, when you go back, that's my favorite thing, is when they go back and they show, like, in Forrest Gump, the scene where it's his grandfather and he's, like, a Ku Klux Klansman. There's tire tracks on the road, right? Like, the crew left clear tire tracks, muddy tire tracks. And so that, you know, that wouldn't exist if it was the 1800s. So that's called the film flub. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I like that. You never go back and watch film flubs? You never looked up famous film flubs?
Yeah, I remember like as a kid watching Little House on the Prairie and Laura Met the Indian Boy and he was wearing a pair of Puma sneakers and I always thought that was odd.
Well, and they said like Braveheart, they had to like edit it all because like people had like, you know, Casio watches on and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, they did that with Game of Thrones. They were like pulling spring bottles all over one.
Yeah, and like Starbucks cups and stuff. Like, give me a break. See, that's that shouldn't be happening on that set. That's because they're getting like too loosey-goosey. As a fine extra that's been an extra, I'm just saying, I know like, you know, some extras aren't leaving. I mean, yeah, they've left stuff on stage and on set, but that's just like them being lazy kind of. I think there was another Game of Thrones this year where they took a wide shot and then they showed them they had the thank you, Trevor, for the $2. They took a really high shot, like a drone shot, and part of the camera crew was in it. It just happened.
That was on, I think, Book of Boba Fett, too. They were showing, like, the buildings, and they were filming, you know how, like, the buildings are a facade in the town? They were shooting the back of it, too, where you could see the whole facade. It's like...
Yeah, I mean...
Yeah.
You can look up the best film flubs, but, yeah, the top 10 movies where you can spot a blah, blah, blah.
The best film flub of all time has to be Twilight Zone, where the helicopter chopped off the heads of all the people on set.
Is that really happened? A bunch of people died? What about that? Was it the Wizard of Oz? The guy hung himself on set? What's the story behind all that? I think
that's
a rumor.
That's like an urban legend. That a dwarf hung himself, and you can see him in the background when they're skipping down the yellow brick road.
I think in Teen Wolf, you could see a guy's dick or something. Did you ever heard about that?
There was a guy jerking off. Yeah.
That's not an accident, dude. How did I miss that? I mean, you have to edit that. You know, as an editor, you watch that because you can miss stuff because you're like trying to get it done. But you would think you'd have to look at that scene 100 times minimum to even edit it, you know.
Braveheart was so historically wrong. That must be a splat bag. Are you a Brit? I was talking to Captain Chokeout who I was like, wait a minute. When you watch Braveheart, who are you rooting for? The England, or you think like William Wallace is a troublemaker? He's like, he's a fucking troublemaker. Like, it's so crazy that, like,
Wallace. Somebody else is... That's so stupid. That's so funny, though.
But they said the same thing when Black Hawk Down was in like, played in Somalia. They were like, yeah, cheering for
no! them. See, that's good ass weed right there. That's some good weed. We need to get like a Somalia's viewing of them watching Black Hawk Down. So they were like cheering it.
They were like, this is fucking great.
Oh my God. How is that not a Saturday Night Live sketch? How is that? That's like the most brilliant thing. That is the most brilliant form of comedy. Because like we look at it, it's like, oh, that's America. Imagine watching those movies that we, you know, the propaganda films that we like. Yeah. But being on the reverse end of it, like, yes, die. That's hilarious.
And it was a big win for them. They, like, wiped out a whole, you know, it was a survival movie for the Americans there. I mean, I guess it kind of was for William Wallace, too. He ended up fucking getting tortured. I guess the English were just like, good, this troublemaker. You know, all the guy wanted to do is fuck his wife. That was an honor, man. Take the honor. So, yeah.
Well, let me just tell you something.
What's that?
So look at the messages I sent you. It's funny. Right before I got on the show, though, Cecil, I'm having freaking a kind of a, you know, I go in front of these breakdowns. I don't know how hard it is to pull it up, but so I messaged you. So there's this guy that just got out of jail here.
And you send it to me on Twitter?
I texted it to you on text. Should I send it to you on Twitter? I'll send it to you on Twitter. Is that better?
Yeah, I can't show text. I mean, unless I just hold up my phone.
No. Let me send it to you on Twitter.
You want me to show it to everybody?
Yeah, like here, I blocked the guy's info. I think it'd be fine, but here, because we got to show this too, because I want to get what the chat has, what they think about this. So this guy, he got out of jail for less than the minimum, and I blanked out his address. And so he just got out of jail, and he got out of jail so fast that they weren't even able to properly warn his victims. Like, they're supposed to, like, if a sex offender gets out, they have like a certain amount of time to tell their offenders, like, hey, this guy's getting out of jail. And like, no, this guy, we can pull up the article too. I'll send you the article as well. That's probably better, the whole article. But my point being is,
pull up the article. Yeah, send me the article and I'll just pull that up. That way I don't fucking expose all my messages, which are all naked, you know, dick.
Yeah,
pics,
I know. I know. Hold on. So I mean, but so basically this guy, you know, abused over 14 girls, and he was also like part of this camp called Camp Kanakuk. And multiple people of that camp have been arrested for abusing girls. So it's like this weird thing. It's like this like predatory pedophiles. And dude, now he's back in in the Weatherford, like right down the street from me. And like, obviously I would never ever want to harm this guy or hurt him. I just want to make that clear. I'd never want to do that. But dude, this guy needs to be interviewed ASAP. I mean, like, you know, ASAP. He just got out of jail. The news is talking about it because my hair is insane. The hairspray kind of looks good like that. But what I'm saying is, I got to go get the camera and interview him. You know what I mean? And so,
yeah,
I think it's
necessary.
Pull them up though, dude. You're going to be like, what? It's really some bad news. This guy, this article. And you know, I don't want him to shoot me, but I'm going to have to like go, like kind of go hang out in his neighborhood. I mean,
I'm pretty sure he doesn't have the right to own a gun anymore.
Yeah, I mean, he shouldn't, but I mean, who knows where he lives? You know, he was an ex-pastor, and I'm thinking about going to the church where the pastor was there. He said that he didn't know, but then after the guy got in trouble, he recommended him to a different church in Arkansas. Here, we got to go through it.
All right, wait 1 second. Jonathan Hurst, $1.99. More drunk, Cecil, your liver can handle it. All right, I'll try. I'll do a shot.
Cheers. Coke Zero.
You look like you lost weight.
No, I haven't. I've been gaining. Don't even talk about my weight. I just think it's my hair or something. But go we'll play the video. Let's not talk about my weight. I'm depressed about my weight, Cecil. I got to get in shape. I've been exercising, but I
didn't know how to share the sound. Hold on. All right, there's a video with this?
Yeah, we can watch the video.
Is this the video here?
Yeah.
Morning, Dan.
Of course, we always have to watch a stupid ad, of course, you know. But so basically, this guy's a serial abuser. I mean, to the nth degree. I mean, he's disgusting.
Yeah, don't be a serial abuser. That's one way it'll gain weight.
Investigation to church members that revealed a former youth pastor sexually abused 14 girls at two different churches.
The former Denton Bible Church
two different churches
is in federal prison right now, serving a sentence for sexually assaulting two girls on church youth trips. Now one of his many victims is sharing her story publicly for the first time with Fox 4 News. And Lori Brown is in studio tonight with more. Lori.
Stephen, Heather, the victim says she wants to shine a light on what happened to the 14 girls because Denton Bible Church kept it in the dark for too long. We are not showing her face and have altered her voice to protect her identity.
A youth group became a feeding ground for a deviant, and we didn't know it. That was thought to be a trusted staff person.
He was very manipulative. He was really good at playing on the emotions of teenage girls. I felt special, and that's what he was preying on.
Denton Bible Church pastor Tommy Nelson, who is also a best-selling author of Christian books, told his congregation on May 1st that he was not only deceived, but used by the church's now former junior high youth director, Rob Shiflett.
One, our church helped send to Dallas Seminary.
This guy's a liar.
The congregation, the church made available by request a 5-page letter summarizing a 10-month-long investigation conducted by a third-party attorney.
We paid these guys to make sure that there was not any cover-up in our church.
Scott Fredericks, that attorney and third-party investigator, is not releasing the lengthy report, citing privacy concerns for the victims. But one of those victims did want to share her story with Fox 4 News.
It was a stack, like two dictionaries full of papers.
For public release, the private investigation was summarized in a 5-page update. It found many failures on the part of Denton Bible Church.
Of course, it's so watered down, but keep going. I wish you could play it at like 1.5 speed.
Did not acknowledge what church leaders knew and when they knew it. Does it feel like they were more?
It's the same bullshit like the Catholic Church. They fucking just they don't want the scandal, so they. And
basically, but here, but well, I don't know if the audio is still playing, but you can go down. I don't know how much is left of it. This is kind of a boring thing, but maybe fast forward. I wanted to just show you the Robert Shiflett. Go down. Maybe you can still watch it because I don't want to bore everybody. But so this guy, look at it, was released on January 11th, just a couple months ago. And this is the guy that abused 14 girls, and he was also at Kanakuk. So now he's just in Weatherford, and nobody's interviewed him yet. So
well, how long did he serve in jail?
Look, less than 25 months. If you go down, he got less than the minimum for abusing 14 girls. So less than like 3 years. I mean, that's 2 years, 2 years in a month. Say that again.
Did he get 14 convictions?
I don't know, but it was 14 girls. Here, let's read the article. Go down. So Cherish victims said they did not receive notice of his early release from the U.S. Department of Justice for more than 6 weeks. An email to the victim said that the advance notice of his release was not possible because it was immediate and or unexpected. Shiflet, 52, is now living in Weatherford, Texas, where he's required to register as a sex offender who is also be under supervision for life.
Yeah, somebody, he must have a hookup because he got released so quickly. Like it said, it was unexpected. They weren't even able to 200 pounds my ass.
Yeah. But
these guys he's lying on it like it's a Tinder.
Get the fuck out of here. And it says, look, risk level not reported, ending registration date, lifetime. So, I mean, his name was only recently was posted on the Texas Sex Offender Registry. Look, go back up. I want to read that real quick. Right there. No. Sex Offender Registry. Yeah. You can keep going down because he was originally listed under a misspelled name. What are the chances? Of course, he gets the old misspelled name gimmick, too. So they can't even find him. So they fixed that. Pastor Tommy Nelson was the head pastor of Denton Bible at the time. The abuse occurred in the late 90s and remains a head pastor. So this guy is still the pastor after all this stuff happened, Cecil.
Yeah, we did a big investigation, and we didn't do anything wrong, it turns out.
So this guy protects pedophiles. So I'm saying I might need to go to his church as well.
Yeah, I mean, this is fucking nuts.
Could you imagine I go to his church in the middle of it and say, why did you, support pedophiles? Well, why don't you step down? This, these children were abused at your church. You should step down.
That's a lot of kids. I mean, that's for one fucking church, 14 victims. It's fucking insane.
And he's still the pastor. Could you imagine? What does the chat say? Chat, what do you think if I went to the church and confronted him? Not just the pastor. I got to confront the pedophile too. But do you think the pastor deserves some questions to be answered?
What do you think? Yes, do it.
Do it. Do it. Yeah. Do it. You gotta give it like 15 seconds. I mean, obviously, we're not gonna hurt anybody. Yeah, everybody wants to do it. Yeah, nobody's getting nothing physical. But I mean, I do think I need to go cause a scene out there.
Bring rope. Do it.
Yeah. Do it, Alex. I think I gotta go.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, doing drag. You guys are so funny in the chat.
Yeah, no, honey trap him.
Well, I just got to get some buddies in there, too, to film, and then I can whip out selfie mode and just be like, you protected a pedophile. You need to step down. 14 kids were abused in this church while you were the pastor in the 90s. And it's still, this is not okay, bud. And
he recommended this guy. Pope? This guy's acting like he's the Pope or something. Step down.
14 kids getting molested in your church? I mean, give me a break, dude. You can't even justify that with a written English language. Like, you're going to be like,
This guy has political connections, I'll tell you right now. The misspelled name on the registry, the fucking early release for 14, and the fact that he's alive because...
Yeah. There's two different people. You understand? Robert Shiflett, who is the youth pastor, he's the one that molested all the children. But who head pastor was, is this guy Tommy Jackson or whatever. I'm going to go confront both of them. I kind of got to do it. It's a little, what we call
this was the molester, and this is the guy who kind of covered Popeyes.
Yes, guy, since the 90s. Yes. And he's still the pastor. He's still the pastor after all that happened.
Well, didn't that same fucking shit happen in what fucking school was that with the coach? Christ,
Sandusky. Oh, and dude, they just found out. Yeah,
it's so weird. These people's reputations are more important than anything else. Like, they even remember that was that scandal with the Olympic the gymnast, the girls, where the doctor was molesting them, and they just covered that.
Michigan State, dude. They all got molested, and that one girl, Simone Biles, right, is still all messed up from it or whatever.
And they said it's like all these people. It's like you would think the most important thing is to protect the kids as soon as you hear it, but that's not where. Time and time again, whether it's the Catholic Church, this church, or fucking Sandusky, or Michigan, or whatever, their first reaction is cover this shit up. It's gonna make us look bad. It's not fucking protect these kids. It's the last thing on their fucking mind. It's fucking insane. It's insane. Yeah,
it really is. I mean, it's just sad. And now it's, I think it's worse than ever. I mean,
Yeah, because they're trying to fucking main. At least back then, people were getting super outraged. It was a universal left and right were like, leave the kids alone. But now you got half the fucking country that's like, oh yeah, sexualize kids and fucking, you know, give mastectomies to fucking 10-year-olds. And although I just saw that there was a one of the first lawsuits started yesterday from a girl who got a double mastectomy at 13 and puberty blockers.
Yeah, she's suing California. Yeah.
And it's and you know, I spoke with Chloe Cole when we were in DC, and she was, you know, telling her story. It's like nobody, not one person ever said, hey, maybe you shouldn't do this. Like, you know, back in the 90s, like I grew up in New York, so I knew trans people, I knew transvestites, transsexuals, you know, cross dressers, whatever, the whole fucking thing. It's New York. But at least when you met somebody who had the surgery, you kind of knew they were fucking committed because they had to go through like 6 years and like psychologically.
Dude, you know what I mean? Cecil, I used to listen to the Howard Stern show all the time that people said, oh, it'd be so hard to get a sex change in America. I always had to go to Venezuela or Guatemala. That they were doing the original tourism because they would be like, oh, it's so hard to get a doctor here to do it. And this was like the 99, you know, this was 2000. This is right around. This is just the other day. Now they're doing it's kids.
Now they're fast tracking preteens, but like just, you know, a little over 20 years ago, it was hard for a fucking adult. Adult would have to go through a battery of years of tests before they made them psychologically okay. You know what this entails. You understand. You know, they were like, hey, you have to understand what this is going to be, and they fucking made adults go. Now they're just fast tracking kids, like fucking yeah, quick, get this shit done before you change your mind. Like Chloe Cole was saying, nobody fucking was like, hey, maybe you shouldn't do this. It was one expert to the next that were like, yeah, you got to get this done, got to get this done, got to get this done. And it's fucking, so we've gone from, you know, now it's like, we're like, why didn't we protect the kids? Now it's like half the country's cheerleading, just fucking, you know, nude fucking readings for children and fucking sex change for children. Like we've gone fucking off the deep end. Like, you know, it's kind of hard to believe that we have to write laws that you can't do sex changes on children, but there are states doing it. And then people are protesting them, calling them hateful for fucking, it's insane.
And we've met Chloe, like, I'm not trying to virtue say, like, we're so cool because we met a detransitioner, but, like, we talked to them, like, they exist. People try to act like kids don't change their mind or something. Like, we don't even let a kid get a tattoo. We don't let him fight in the military. We don't let him vote. Yeah, we're going to let him do stuff.
It's the same as celebrating a cutter. It's like, I swear to God, in a few years, they're going to be celebrating cutters. Like, look how brave she is. She's cutting her arms every day. Like, what the fuck? You're mutilating yourself. It's like, yes, isn't that brave? It's like maybe there might be a psychological issue here that should be looked into. No. You're being fucking judgmental.
Well, that's because everybody gets you win by being the biggest victim. You know what I mean? That sounds so stupid, but it's like, oh, it's just, it's not even like a meritocracy. It's like, oh, who's the biggest victim? Oh, they deserve to get the, you know, biggest hand up. And that's why we have people like, and I don't want to get all political because it's so lame, but like Pete Buttigieg, who's the transportation secretary, basically because he's gay, not because of anything else. So, you know, it's just sad that that's like what we're reading. Qualification.
Yeah, of course. And you saw the guy in front of the guy who's the Swiss bank.
Which one
that collapsed. He comes in every other day. He comes in sometimes dressed as a woman, sometimes one of the banks that was just fucking failed.
He's a gender bender. You're talking about Silicon Valley Bank or what?
No, not Silicon. Bank Swiss.
Bank Swiss.
Yeah. That guy.
SUI.
And it's like, that was the best guy. And the funniest fucking thing somebody pointed out was, hey, instead of like complaining that this bank's failed, shouldn't we be celebrating the fact that the board was all women? And it's like, it's like, yo, that's a self-owned, like, if I ever fucking, it's like, yeah, Cecil, let's celebrate.
Let me tell you the scariest thing that can happen to a human being on Earth. You just woke up, you rush to the airport for the 6 a.m. flight, you barely made it through security, you get on the freaking airplane, you're walking to your seat, and you look in the cockpit, and you see two women. Nothing is scarier in the world than that experience.
No, getting pulled over by two women cops is because you're
gonna. Oh, You're done. Just quit. You might as well shoot yourself.
That's a. It's a
truth. And I'm not even anti-woman. I'm just saying.
They're a little jumpy.
Yeah, you know what I mean? They're trying to fly the plane. They're like texting their ex.
Jay Bama said when he saw the victim speaking, said the victim seemed fat. And you know, a little. We don't have the classiest crowd here, but Jay's pretty classy. Jay Bama said, Alex needs to get on the gas.
Yeah, I know. I need to start smoking that Mary Jane like the old Don Terrius. Dude, what was that? Not the crazy. Do I seem low energy today? No, I'm fine. I am kind of tired. Do I seem low energy? I just did my show where I yelled and screamed, so it's kind of nice to kind of sit back and talk to you. You know, not all high key. I am a little tired and I'm a little congested, to be honest. I'm at like 69%.
You see the English. The English are fucking starting to chime in about Braveheart. See, who mentioned that troublemaker was? See.
Yeah, I know. He has a point, though.
Gotta watch it from the other angle. This guy was a real pain in the ass.
Dude, those Somalians were cheering for Tom. I mean, they wanted Tom Hanks to die in that movie. I'm the captain now. They watch that in Somalia. They're like, go get him! They got the boat! Yeah, they're like, no! But you know, they were cheering.
We're the captain!
We're the captains now! We're the captains now! That's such a good perspective.
Dude, you should rent a theater in Minnesota and have one night only Black Hawk Down free
ticket. Re-edit though. I need to edit and re-edit Black Hawk Down to where they win and then show
they did win. That's why they loved it.
Excuse me, Black Hawk Down. But I'm thinking about the boat movie or whatever with the Somalian pirates. Hawk Down. Yeah, I mean, I guess they knocked down the Black Hawk helicopter and then what? That's the one with Tom Sizemore, right?
They like picked off the whole platoon basically
stuck
in Mogadishu. So yeah, it was a feel-good movie for Somalian terrorists. It was like a big win. Is this second episode going to get copyright struck too? We'll see. I'm gonna try not to.
I think we played news. I don't know if you I think you can show news.
I got struck for let me stop sharing. I got struck for playing the Bionic Man intro for 30 seconds while we talked over it. And then I got struck for my last stream for playing Drew Barrymore when she was, you know, crawling on her hands and knees to see with Dylan Mulrooney. Did you see that clip?
Oh, yeah. What? You got a strike for that one because that's NBC's?
I know, but we were talking over it. Like, I could fight.
Oh, I know. It is fair use. And, I mean, you're obviously, you know, like.
Commentary on it, so.
Duh. I mean, it fits under the guidelines, but these people just copyright strike you, and then you have to go to, you know, basically go to court or file something. It's such a pain in the ass.
Yeah, so they won't – it doesn't hurt your channel, but you just don't get – it takes your monetization, basically. Greeting, Tatsukama. Calling me Cecilia, though. Cecilia's not here. Yeah, so
– that's your female alter ego.
Yeah. So he's saying that the guy in Texas is bad, but not as bad as William Wallace. See,
the Brits. Okay, Jobby the Creator. You 2 pounds though. That's like $3 Americans. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, hold. Well, hold. Michael Tynan, $50. All right,
I know, dude. I didn't even know McDonald's had a 50-piece McNugget like that. Congratulations, yeah. Dude. That feels good.
Michael, God
take a shot. Is that what you have to do? You have to take a shot? Oh, wow.
I don't have to, but.
That's what you do. It's a big sip. Oh, is that whiskey? What is that?
It's Jack Daniels, yeah.
It's Jack Daniels. Oh, let me see. That's some sort of signature Jack Daniels.
That's a rye. That's their rye.
And let me see the price tag on that sucker. Let's see
it. It's cheap. It was on sale. That's why I bought it. Like 25 bucks or something.
That's still kind of 25 bucks, and that's a liter? Is that a handle?
It's a liter.
You're not poor though. 25 bucks a liter. I mean, what the heck, dude?
But I like it. Like, I like that one. So when I saw it was on sale, I was like, oh, cool.
Did you just hit that no chaser?
I drink whiskey all day long, man.
No chaser, dude. No.
That's right. We don't drink when we hang out because you don't drink.
I don't drink. I'm a puss. Wait, dude. No. dude. No chaser. You're not going to chase it. Not even a little gulp of water. Not even a beer. Because even a beer will help wash it down a little.
No.
You got me feeling like my stomach's hurting now, guys. Be very careful with this, with what you drink. You know, I honestly, I don't fault anyone for drinking. Like, I'm not even anti-alcohol, but I get so hungover, Cecil. Like, you're in better shape than me. Even when I was in good shape, like, I don't know. I feel like my body's not built for alcohol.
You know, it's personally. You got to put in the hours.
You think that's what it is, the tolerance? I'm just saying, I think I'm actually allergic to alcohol, and it took me until I was about 30 to realize that. And then maybe I'm not, you know, like, I don't know. I'm a puss. Everybody in the chat's making fun of me. I mean, you know, listen, I like to sometimes puff the devil's lettuce every once in a while, you know, to relax things if we're in a legal state and it's legal, you know, or whatever. But, yeah, I don't really drink. I don't pop pills. I definitely don't do coke now. Now the drugs with fentanyl, dude. You're so jacked up. Yeah, right, dude. I wouldn't touch this stuff now.
All you kids out there. Yeah, I mean, I'm glad I had my
yeah, drug in college.
Days, my drug days back when, but I would be fucking frightened. They put it in pills. They put it in your coke is going to have
everything.
Everything. So just, yeah, kids that are just going, like, they're like, oh, why do these kids take fentanyl? It's like, they weren't taking fentanyl. They bought like a fucking bag of coke.
Or a Xanax bar or something. That's how my buddy died, Clark Gable. That's how he died. He bought a pill that he thought was like a pain pill or Xanax or something, had fentanyl in it. He never woke up.
Yeah, so it sucks. You know, they're ruining drugs for the kids. It's really, we really got to go to war with China. But
World War III needs to happen right now.
So, yeah, it does suck because I guess the only thing you really can fuck with is weed. Which I kind of go into a catatonic state from. Like,
do you remember that? What is it? You took a puff of Don Terry's joint inside the Longfellow building. These people have never, and I'm not saying these people like were above or by any means, but what I'm trying to say, there's a lot of people that've been in these buildings. It's hard to describe the level of tension, and everybody's looking at you when you're in an official Capitol building. And then while being high makes it way more paranoid. You're already paranoid. You're already like, I'm not even supposed to be here. And then you add the level of THC that kind of like carpet bombs your whole anxiety level just to boom.
So, yeah. And you and Don Terrius are, you know, practitioners. I was just a tourist. So I have no tolerance for that shit. So, and of course the police hone in on me like fucking, and I'm like, I think they wanted to talk to Don Terrius, but they didn't want
to see. Yeah, they were afraid to talk to him. You know they were, and they kind of were afraid. They kind of talked to me, and they knew I was kind of giving them the business. They just kind of looked at you because they probably could spot that you were probably, you know, on cloud nine or whatever. You're sitting like on the balcony for a second. You had to take a load off for a second. We all did. And then we went into Congressman Nels. And you know Congressman Nels, Troy Nels, he's been on my show, but I got to have him back. I got to call him out. You know, he was one of the first politicians to go to East Palestine and drink the water and do the gimmick where I'm drinking the tap water.
Whoa. Why would he do that?
Because he's trying to say it's back to normal.
Ooh. We'll check in on him in a couple weeks.
Yeah, I know. I mean, he just had a cup. He's like, this is water. And I believe he would do it. And I would do it. I mean, somebody's saying, I don't think Troy's a shill, but I mean, he's so nice. I mean, I don't think Troy's a shill. I don't think that. I think he just thinks that's what's the right thing to do. He's from Texas, personally, right? Yeah, he's from Texas, like Houston.
Huh. So what the hell is he doing in Ohio drinking the water?
He's a congressman. He's trying to get some clout. He goes on my show. See, there's 432 of them, I believe, if I'm correct. So they're all trying to be like AOC or MTG. They all want a nickname, a gimmick, a hit, a lick, because none of them can even get that much clout. Like, you know, you got to remember in these states, like,
they're competing with AOC and her titties, man.
Yeah, but that's only in like New York. Like in places like Idaho and some of these states, it's not as hard to become a politician and get in there as you think. I mean, it is a challenge always, but I'm not trying to discredit the you know, position of being in Congress.
No, I'm saying that they're competing with her for like media, the national.
Exactly. Dude, you don't know any of these people. You were there in the Capitol Hill. We walked by these politicians. Like, who the fuck are you? I don't fucking know. I mean, unless you're somebody that's causing drama.
I know who I have a gimmick. I know eye patch. I know tits.
But that's because Pete Davidson made fun of him, and then he went on Saturday Night Live, and then he went on Joe Rogan. That's what put him over. We wouldn't even, dude. Ron DeSantis was a congressman for 4 years, I believe, or eight. Nobody knew who he was.
Right. That's true.
Now he's about to be the president. Now think about that, guys. It's not easy to get the attention. And some people probably don't want attention. They get there and they're like, oh, crap. Let me just get the donors and let me just try to do whatever I can to keep this position.
Did you see the AI pictures of Trump getting arrested?
Yeah, we shared it on the show. It was so funny. That made me laugh so hard. It's such a joke, dude. It's such a shame for America, for us to do this to a president. Like,
is it actually happening or?
I don't know, but I mean, dude, it's not.
I wonder if there's a pushback from the Democratic Party because they're like, hey,
people have killed people.
We've had an unwritten rule that we don't fucking, you know, go after, like, this is really going after small ball shit. Like payoffs for an affair. Like, we already have, you have to go back some. So some prosecutor is going to be like, I'm prosecuting Bill Clinton for it. We have the woman saying I was paid off for the, like, they could go back and fucking start, or just currently they're like, all right, we had this unwritten rule. The fucking cuffs are off. That means Republican prosecutors could now do fucking like, the Democrats never think things through. Like, just like the fucking Supreme Court vote, you know, where they're like, no, you can't vote on it. Now they got a stacked thing because we use their fucking dirty trick against them. We got a stacked fucking it always blows up in their face. So maybe somebody's like, hey, maybe don't do this because this shit's going to blow up in our face when fucking Republican prosecutors start fucking dragging Democratic politicians in for every nickel and dime bullshit because we just opened the doors for that to be normal. Like, if you're going to do it to the president, we could do it to anybody. So they're going to fucking go after every fucking, it's going to go back and forth. They're going to be arresting. And you know, it's one thing if he's like embezzling millions or some kind of fucking, but
which Biden has done. But in the season,
Biden has done.
I'm saying, would you arrest the president if he got a DWI? I don't even think you'd do it for that. I think you'd have to give him a pass. I mean, I don't know why the president would be driving, but you know what I mean? And it sucks that there's a two-party justice system, you know, rules for thee, but not for me. But dude, he was the president. He has Secret Service detail. He can't necessarily go to jail. It's not going to exactly work. I mean, what the heck? That kind of trumps, not to use that as a pun, you know, some small crime. And I think it's for tax evasion because they didn't label the payment to his attorney, Michael Cohen.
It's a fine
payoff.
And the thing is, the DA bumped, it's a misdemeanor what he did. And the DA bumped it up to a felony. Now, just the same DA in New York City, armed robbery has been knocked down to a misdemeanor in New York City. So this is the fucking insanity that's going on. This same guy has knocked down armed robbery in New York City is a misdemeanor. My brother's friend almost got raped. This woman, she was fucking pregnant too. She fucking, in broad daylight, like, people came and helped her. Fucking guy gets arrested. She goes to the supermarket a block away the next day. The guy's in there.
Because the bail reform law, you get right out.
It's a desk appearance ticket. You go before a judge and he gives you a ticket and that's it. That's it. And you're out.
But listen to this, and I'm not trying to be devil's advocate because you're there. Dude, I don't want to say hate. I really don't like these guys. They're the good liars. They kind of do what I do, but like the liberal version of it. And they were trying to troll outside of the Trump protest. And they did make a point, and then I looked it up, and they weren't like – I got a little different number than they said. But, you know, New York is like only in top 50 most dangerous cities in America.
Yeah, that's only because they have like such anti-terrorist fucking –
I know, but there's so much bad stuff that happens in New York. Like, I guess that's maybe dangerous crime because there's so much crime there. Yeah, but I was surprised that it wasn't. I thought it'd be number one or number two.
It's what's happening is we're seeing the slide backwards. You had 20 years of Giuliani and Bloomberg, who basically just took. He didn't change a thing from Giuliani, like. You know, afterwards when he wanted to run for president, and he's like, I regret everything I did, but the city was a fucking paradise.
But also when it has that ranking, it's because the cops don't arrest people and stuff too. You know what I mean? There's a reason for that too. It's because they're not arresting as many people or whatever.
It's getting worse. And here, that's the other thing. The crime rate, it's definitely artificially deflated. It's nowhere near, you know, 80s, early 90s. Nowhere fucking near. That was absolutely like insanity. It was like,
did you talk about that? How bad was it? I'm trying to look up the NYC crime right now. Yeah, you, I remember you telling me you worked at some hospital and you said everybody would come in there shot up.
I remember going, I broke my thumb while I was bar backing at my friend's mother owned a bar, and they dropped a case of beer on my thumb and it snapped. And I went to Elmhurst Hospital. I was like 16 and they're like, yeah, go get it bandaged. And I'm in there for like an hour. And then like, just people are just bleeding all over the fucking place. And then like, there's a cop in the emergency room. And I'm just like, his radio starts going crazy. Like shots fired. Fucking 2 seconds later, the door is just open. The dude walks in with like gunshot wounds to his stomach. I'm like, I'm never getting this fucking thumb looked at. Like, so we literally got in a car, drove all the way to Long Island, and I had it done in like 15 minutes. But like going into like a New York City hospital during like that time was fucking absolutely, it was insane. It was like a, you know, it was like a war zone.
Well, dude, you can type in Daily Mail right now. New York hospitals, they're overrun right now. And there's a picture of like a guy with his gown and his butt out. You look up, type in Daily Mail, New York hospitals overrun. There's just one of their top articles was about how overrun the hospital.
Yeah, yeah. There's like there's urine all over the floor and people laying in the hall. It's
and just in the hallway. They don't have rooms for people. They're just on beds in the hallway for hours on end.
I got to get the fuck out of here, man. Soon.
Where are you going to go, though? Florida? Where are you going to go? Texas? Probably
South Carolina, Florida, Texas. I don't know.
South Carolina would be cool, too. I mean, I would go to the beach if I had to leave Texas. Now that I'm in Texas, I've been here my whole life. I'm probably going to stay. But
I don't know.
If I had to move right now, definitely not California. I was in California, dude. Every Uber I got in, just waiter, just the people. I was at a cheaper hotel, but just the people at the hotel had the saddest vibes. Like they were just struggling. Like at any minute they were going to blow their brains out. I know that sounds like I'm being dramatic. I know it sounds like that, but I'm telling you, dude, as a matter of fact, it even ended on like the high spot, as you'd say in professional wrestling. I was in no hurry. I had plenty of time. I like to go to the Amex lounge before I go to the gate. So like I had time. It was an early morning thing. It was so hard to get a thing, but still I had plenty of time. But the guy, Uber driver, is like such a hurry to drop me off to go get another fare. Dude, he was like hauling ass, going like 100 miles an hour. I mean, it was like making me sick. And I could just tell the stress, like the way the guy was driving. And I was like, I never even said slow down. Actually, looking back, I probably should have. But dude, I could like feel the stress that this guy had to drop me off and get another fare just to make it, like just to make ends meet, you know? And like, and I've been there too where I couldn't make ends meet, really. You know, it's just stressful. Like you'll do anything. Like, and that's the vibe I got from everybody in California. And there are some, I guess, wealthier people I'm kind of ran into.
Well, yeah, it's becoming really like two-tiered. It's like fucking homeless in the street, fucking people barely scraping by, and then ultra rich.
Yeah, I know.
Bless you.
Wow.
COVID. Bless you.
Yeah. Kind of. I am kind of sick. I mean, I don't feel that bad, but I feel a little wonky, to be honest. To be 100% honest.
All right, Alex, here's a question for you. What did the pastor lie about?
What did the senior... Oh, just that he wasn't aware about it happening at his church. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. You know, there's going to be some kickback. But it happened at his church, and he said that he didn't know about it happening the whole time, the head pastor. But even once he heard about the allegations, he still, if you read the whole article, he recommended the Robert Shiflett guy, the molester, to a church in Northwest Arkansas. So the pastor's, you know, already been proven a liar. He recommended after him. He recommended him to another diocese, whatever, another
that's
church.
Kind of what, that's kind
found
of
out the, about the allegations.
That's what the Catholic Church did too. The bishops would just send them to another church. They'd be like, rather than deal with they didn't call the police on them, right?
Yeah, and I'll tell you this.
That pastor didn't call the police.
Yeah, and let me tell you something, Jay. To be honest, even if he didn't do anything, if I was the pastor of a church and there's a serial molester that molested 14 kids knowingly and went to jail for it, you would step down if you were the leadership of that church. I mean, there's no excuse for that. I don't care if he built that church. You know, he should be disgraced for letting that even happen. Over time, over years, this happened over years. So.
50. Oh, wow. I'm going to get drunk, man. I'm starting to feel that last one.
I know. You took a swig from the bottle. You really don't have to take that big a swig this time. You took a huge one from the bottle just a second ago. Right.
Jerk off juggernaut for $50. Thank you, sir. Hail to the best YouTube co-host, Cecil. Drink, fucker.
Bottoms up.
All right. Ooh. All right. Alex, what a pleasant surprise.
John Q, I miss your drops. John
Everybody, Q. Right now, when you got a moment, there in Alex's, in the description below, is the link to Alex's YouTube channel. Sub it right now. He does a show. Yes. How many days a week is it, Alex?
3 days a week. Pimp on a blimp. You guys got to go sub it. But Cecil, before we even talk about me, I really appreciate you guys. You have such a great audience, man. You and what you built up with the Jack Show. I don't want to see kiss your butt, but dude, it's really insane.
No, go ahead. That's fine.
No, but to cultivate a community like that, dude, it takes a lot of hard work, and you really have done it. And, dude, you got 1,000 people watching you on a Tuesday night. It's pretty strong. I mean, there's nights where I can't get 1,000. So you're a real pimp on a blimp. So, yeah, anybody that wants to support the channel, please do. But real quick, I got to ask you this. Do you have a Logitech Brio webcam?
Yeah, I do.
You need to go to your webcam settings. You got to turn off the... Yeah, because this will help you. You got to do this because it's the worst. It's the best. It's good quality. But if you do not turn off the autofocus, you can just go to autofocus, you turn it off, and then it won't continue to do that. But when you don't turn it off, it's always doing it. It's the worst camera when it comes to this in the world. As I can tell because I know it. I could tell you had the Logitech Brio that fast. But if you go to the settings, you do it where you turn it, or you just make it focus 24/7. It'll even look sharper than it looks right now.
I'm not gonna fuck around with this right now, though.
I'll explain to you how to do it later. Yeah, I'll explain to you how to do it later. It's kind
of hard. I have a feeling the screen will end.
I know it's such a pain. They make it so hard to do it for some reason too. But you got to do that. But I mean, the camera quality is good. I'm using one right now. I love it. But if you turn off the autofocus, it'll be a lot better.
Credit Suisse, thank you. So yeah, I was blanking on the name of it. But it's so funny. It's like they're like, yeah, but these are really like progressive. Like they're all woman board. Failed. Fucking. Then it's got the guy in charge of the whole fucking thing. It's like on Wednesdays he identifies as a girl, and it's like him, and it's like. It looks like Herman Munster in a fucking wig. It's like, give me a like, you're not even trying, bro.
That's what I'm saying. These guys aren't even trying. People got so mad because I simped for Blair White, and I probably did simp too much now looking back, because I was just trying to be nice. Blair White, you know, it was nice enough to come on my show.
It's fine. If you like the person and whatever, you're cool with them, that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to
But I'm saying, at least, if people are going to hate this and I scrim my eye, like, at least Blair is a passable as a woman. You'd be like, what? That's the problem. Half of the 95% of these trans people, it's like the Pizza Hut meme. You can put a Chinese restaurant in a Pizza Hut, but everybody's going to know that was a Pizza Hut, dude. You know, I mean, it's just how it works, bro.
Yeah. It's like, you got to give it a try. I mean, I'm sure, I guess everybody can't be Blair White. I get it. But like some of these guys, it's just like, you know, they ain't even fucking trying.
They're just like, I want to shit in the women's bathroom. Like they're not, that's what I'm saying. Like, what's that one guy, Jeffrey Marsh or whatever, that's been going by? He like has a mustache and stuff. Like he's not even a woman. That he's just being weird. So, and it's a mockery to women. They call, if you like wear blackface, if you like, you know, say certain words or use certain accents, they call that cultural appropriation, which they equal as racism, basically. Yet these guys can culturally appropriate any hoe or woman they want. You know, they can literally make a woman seem disgusting. They can make, you know what I'm saying? It's a caricature of a woman. It's not even like a classy demonstration of a woman.
No. This is what people were pointing out. I think Matt Walsh was one, but I was pointing this out a while ago. I'm like, Dylan Mulvaney does not act like a woman. He acts like a flamboyantly gay man. There's absolutely nothing different between Dylan Mulvaney before he was, when he's like, I'm a girl now, and now he's a girl. It's the same personality, same voice, same everything. It's just he's wearing a dress. You know what I mean? It's like, no, you're just, there's nothing feminine about you. You're just a, you know, you're feminine for a man, you know, the way like a flamboyantly gay guy would be like, all right, he's kind of femme. But you're not not female. Like you're not, he's not, there's nothing feminine like in the female nature. He's just flamboyantly gay man. That's it. Like,
Yeah, and he's just kind of like a whatever, you know, flamboyant, you know, lady guy or whatever. But, dude, the weird thing was that Eloise, how they decorated his Plaza Hotel room, yeah, like Eloise. Why is he wanting to dress up like a child? Isn't that, like, is that okay? Is that okay? Now we can just role play as whatever we want to be as children now. Adults can just role play as children, and we're going to encourage that.
I'm immature.
You and I are like not some. We're not the, you know, beacons of maturity by any means. But I mean, at least we act like we don't act like actual 12-year-olds like these freaks. I mean, give me a break.
Yeah, he was running around dressed as like he was dressed like a 10-year-old girl, like fucking, and running around the Plaza Hotel.
That's weird. That's weirder than weird. Like that happened. Like as an avant-garde art piece, that's kind of funny, I guess, or whatever. You have a guy. I mean, like I'm just saying, like artistic or whatever. But the fact that we encourage us that it's okay, like it's just so odd. It's so peculiar. Like it's just not okay. You know, we're just encouraging this. Yeah, I'm saying, like, you know, it just doesn't make any sense.
Russell Hall, I know it. I just was fucking blanked out. You, like, you can't forget something for a minute. I was like the Swiss bank. I forget it. Quit it.
People, but dude, it goes from like.
But thank you for the $5. I'll read it. You trade the stocks and you don't know Credit Suisse. Why am I not surprised? Okay. Yeah, yeah. It's clearly grooming. It's trying to appeal to children. It's acting like a child. It's putting on the fucking performance of a child. Like, who is this to appeal to? Like, honestly, you name me the person who that's to appeal to. What's the point of him dressing? Like, it's clearly to appeal to obviously. Children. Like, that's, and the same thing with the Jeffrey Marsh guy. Is that, that's the name, Jeffrey?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. So his whole thing is like,
Well, even the Eloise thing, like, he didn't paint that room. Like, they, like, tried to do that as, like, a movie thing, like, show kids. Like, that was, like, a high production art, weird sex thing. Like, it's just so weird that this is all – it's kind of like Marina Abramovich spirit cooking. Have you ever heard of spirit cooking?
Yeah, yeah.
I know that sounds crazy, but that's, like, satanic and blood and semen, but it's, like, these weird rituals. That's what, like, this is. This is, like, some sort of, like, transitional ritual that they're putting him in the Plaza Hotel, giving him, like – letting him go to the White House, giving him a TV special or something, you know, whatever they call it, made for TV special. I mean, they're artificially inflating this guy for what reason? He's at
the goddamn White House, man. Biden spent time with, like, what the fuck is going on? But yeah, I always thought, like, when he first came around, I thought it was a troll. Like,
Jeffrey Marsh, like that other guy. What about the other person that has a long hair and I think he has a mustache too? I forget that person's name. I think they were trolls at first.
And then they got so much that they just went with it because they're like, but the best is that guy in Canada with the triple G tits and stuff. He was a troll.
Did you see that? Yeah, they said, found out that that was a
you could have wrestling deal. You could have figured it. I knew he was a troll from the beginning because people looked into him and they were like, he got in trouble like a year or two ago. He got suspended as a teacher because he didn't use a kid's pronouns or some shit like that. It was like, he didn't go for the woke stuff. So he came in and was like, okay. He's like, fire me now. Fire. And basically they can't fire him because they are now playing by their own rules. So first of all, they're like, well, he's a man when he leaves the school. And it's like, well, he could just say, I'm gender fluid. Do you not believe in gender fluid? So the way they've fucking counteracted this is he's going to be just basically paid until his pension and then get his pension, but never have to go to work. He just got a free fucking paycheck.
Yeah, you think that if that happens, that's epic. If he just gets to be on paid leave, that's what he's on right now.
And they cannot fire him without being like, gender fluidity isn't real. You have to prove that you're really, because that fucks up their whole narrative, because now there has to be a board to decide whether you are really a girl when you say you're a girl. Like, they fucks up. So this guy was the ultimate fucking troll, the best troll of all fucking time. And I knew this like right from the beginning when they said he got in trouble for not, you know, it was like some kind of bullshit infraction he got into. And I was like, this motherfucker was like, I know what happened. He's like, all right, I'm going to shove this shit down your throat. And the fact that they came in and defended him too is great.
you're going to look at my big titties. I mean, give me a freaking break, you know? It's just like, we should have known that was a gimmick the whole time. And then the reporter, like the Rebel News reporter that did it or whatever, got kicked out of that school board meeting or that city council for wearing the titties. It shows you how stupid we are. Like, I go and did a dance about the vaccine and scrubs. We're so, like, starved for content. One guy wearing fake prosthetic breasts was, like, the biggest thing for, like, 2 weeks.
Yeah. I was watching one of yours the other – oh, man, I fucking love the Vegas one, man.
I know. That one's been going up. That one's been blowing up because 50 Cent reshared it. So it's, like, every freaking – you know, urban channel, like black type, you know, you know, Instagram page shared it. Dude, it blew up. And man, I'm like freaking coughing. I'm all congested. How are you feeling? Is it cold in New York?
60 degrees today. It was sunny.
did you go to Wet Spot or anything? I saw Chrissy or them. Or have you been up to the compound in a while?
I was there 2 weeks ago and had a good time.
I remember seeing some Twitter or something.
Now it's a porn star, and she was like supposed to come on tonight, but I spoke with her manager. But I've been like running around this week, so I didn't really put anything together.
What about that one? Was that on air where the guy was licking her butt? Were you in there?
I was sitting right there, man. She asked me to do it, and
politely declined that. You don't need to film me.
Politely declined.
She wanted to come on
this show. You know, let me see. Her manager, who's another porn star, has been.
What happened to that guy? So he like licked her butthole, and then he just kind of.
He was just from the audience. He was just a guy from the audience who was like a huge fan of hers and was.
Did he like go to the bathroom and crank it? I mean, he was like in her butthole, dude. He was like. Like he was, I'm just saying, it wasn't some playful thing. He was like sex, dude. It was like more aggressive than I am with my girlfriend, dude. Seriously.
No, this guy's been waiting for this moment his whole life.
He was really so happy.
We need a volunteer. Moment. He's like, I'll do it. He was like really nerdy too. He's like, oh, I'll do it. I'll do it. Fucking voice cracking.
I gotta go to one of these porn deals, one of those porn conventions. I think
just go to the Wet Spot on Monday night. Like I should have went there yesterday because she had I think three porn stars as her guests, and she's like, you're welcome to, like, I don't have to get invited. She's like, you could come on anytime you want. So I should have went. Well,
listen to this, Cecil. This is inside baseball about my show. If you guys want to know, it's Prime Time with Alex Stein on the Blaze. You can watch it for free on YouTube. The link's in the description. But so I had this teacher, but I think she's a mom too. I'm not sure. She's a teacher that got fired because she got asked to resign because she had an OnlyFans account, and she'd actually got out of teaching, started OnlyFans, and then like after the pandemic got back into teaching. So she kind of didn't plan on going back into teaching, but long story short, some kids found the profile, started following, looking at her naked boobs and yada, yada, yada. And she has a very racy Instagram page, and I invited her on the show, and you know, full stop. I think the Blaze would like, they definitely free speech. They let me have her on, but they're like, Alex, you shouldn't be. They literally said, full stop. You should not be so sympathetic to, you know, an OnlyFans actress like that. Like, you know, you got to have a little more respect basically for our network. And they're right. But said they were 100% right. I was a little too nice. I should have, you know, they're like, you got to. They're like,
I saw that episode.
You were having. I was simped too hard. And they were right. I heard that from multiple people, you know, like. Multiple people, not just fans, but multiple people at the Blaze. They're like, hey, you know, other co-hosts. And they were right. I should have been more so. Listen, so now I'm in my predicament now where I'm having on this next girl tomorrow in studio. Her name's Lauren Compton. Look her up. Let the audience see her. She's hot. She's in Playboy. But she's more talented than this girl. And she's got an OnlyFans. But she knows my content. She's a fan of my content. So I think, but like what I'm saying is I'm in this predicament now where I'm going to have her on my show, but I cannot be. And I'm not really pro OnlyFans. I don't even like OnlyFans. I think OnlyFans is actually toxic. You know, like that's actually how I feel. I do feel like people should have the legal right to do it if you're above age. You know, I mean, I'm a libertarian in that mindset, but I don't think it's good. And so I just got to be a little more fervent.
Yeah, with how I'm not, like, you don't have to endorse it, but you could be like, yeah, she's cute.
Yeah, she's hot. She's hot. She's naked all over the internet. So it's like, I'm not going to like cuss her out by any means, but I have to be just a little you know what I mean? I had to be a little more less endorsing of OnlyFans, which is how I should be, which is how I am. So it's not like I'm like actor, going to be twisting my arm to do it. But my problem is I see these titties, I see this nice smile, and I simp. It's hard because when they're nice to me in person, I can be mean to a guy. I can be mean to like a politician that I think's evil. But just like a nice girl that's being nice to me, especially a pretty girl, is very disarming to me. I hate that I admit that. You know, I would be like I would never see the child by any means, but like I've won a vagina from what those spy movies would definitely be able to like get me, you know, that's how that would be my weakness. It wouldn't be like my mission.
You'd like you'd go for Fang Fang, is what you're saying?
Yes, I'm saying. Yeah, I go for Fang Fang all day. As long as she's legal, I check her ID. I mean, you know, and then I get caught. So yeah, women are my weakness sometimes when I'm nice because I don't want to be mean to a woman. I would never hit a woman. Like when Dana White, and I tried to throw him under the bus, but you saw the video where like his wife slapped him and then he, you know, kind of slapped her back. And I got a lot of heat for that. A lot of conservatives like equal rights, equal lefts. Like she started it. But still, dude, even if a girl tried to beat you up, Cecil, you'd beat her ass. Like it wouldn't even be close. So
right.
It's just we're just not equal. I don't believe men should be able to compete against women in sports either. Like I just some rules you gotta. Those are.
I mean, he's a big guy. I mean, obviously he was pulling his punches. He could have fucking, you know.
He could have really fucked her up. But still, why even fuck her up? I mean, I guess he's trying to send a message. But dude,
he's having a couple drinks. She's smacking him, and he just. I don't know. Like I don't think it's a good idea. No. You know, no. I'm always. Idea. Listen, every dude has been smacked by a girl, and what you do is you just well, I could kill you if I wanted to, and you walk away. It's like you just you bite down and you walk away. You know what I mean? You can't do it. That's you just can't. Like you will, you know, you're gonna get fucking killed.
But no matter what, dude. If a girl punches me 25 times, like when we were at Barstool, we even said it, dude. It's just. You gotta go. If a girl is stabbing you with a knife, you know.
I know. If a stranger, like a woman on the street, is like a mad woman, like just comes over and saw, I will knock her out. No, like in New York City, if some girl just comes over and it's like and starts hitting me, I'm knocking her out. Like I don't know you. Like I'm being attacked by you. I'm knocking you out. Like that.
Some homeless woman that would be scary. Like the woman from Home Alone. That's so funny. Our old movies used to like glamorize the homeless woman. She was like a bird whisperer and she was kind of nice.
No, they're all fucking nuts and they'll fucking, you know, right. You know, someone starts like trying to rub their feces on you. Like, well, you're a woman's and I will knock you out. Like that type of shit. But if it's like a girlfriend or like, it's like, you know what? I'm walking away and this is the end of the fucking relationship here because you know what I mean? This is it. Like you walk away and then you never look back. But you can't fucking. They're trying to get you to hit. You know what I mean? They're trying to get a reaction. So it's like don't fall for it. But like as far as like some crazy person in the street that just because they're a woman, like no, if you're fucking attacking me, I'm knocking your ass out. Like that's that. I'll deal with that later. like for you when you're doing those things, if some Antifa girl starts like punching you in the face, like
no, I wouldn't punch her because I played football, dude. I would get you gotta people punch you, you can't react. That's
and also you don't a lot of times you don't know if it's a guy or a girl anyway when they're all in those black costumes and shit.
Yeah, and they're all in the mask. I mean, a lot of times you can kind of tell just like a guy's posture and a girl's posture, actually, believe it or not, are different. But you know what I mean. It's like, dude, I don't know.
I've seen those guys
get left. I just still don't think I wouldn't hit a girl. I'd run away from it.
It's not recommended. I'm just saying, like in a situation where you're being attacked on the street, like that's fair.
Anthony Cumia, yeah, it didn't work out well for him. So I'm going to be in New York in 2 weeks. What are we going to do? You know, don't say I told the little we have maybe tentatively something going on. But are you going to be out of town? I'll be there March 31st.
How many days are you going to be here? Just that day?
No, I'll be there till the 4th, I think.
Okay.
You should get Stardust on the Jack Show and Simcast. Yeah. So that's a good Ron Martin. Sorry, I'm just looking at the chat. Yeah, Stardust would be good on the Jack Show and the Simcast because she's kind of a liberal, but she's more grounded. You know, she's like grounded in reality. She's not
Stardust.
Like a really liberal. she's like does a lot of internet debates, and she's just, I don't know, she has just a funny way about her. I don't know how to explain it. Like, she's just, I think she has a very funny personality.
You know what is weird is because I've met a couple like porn stars on this last one. I don't know her politics.
This girl's not a porn star. Sorry, she's just like a
okay. Yeah, she's, I'm just like saying. Back to what we were talking about before, because I'm looking at this girl here, your OnlyFans girl, and a lot of these girls, not the last one, not Holly Hendricks, who we were hanging out with the other week. I don't know her politics. She's on another level of like insanity. Like, you know, we didn't get into political talk, but I would imagine she's pretty left wing. But most of the girls, like, it was really weird. Like, hardcore porn girls are based. They're like, it's the weirdest.
Yeah, it is kind of weird. Yeah.
It's so fucking weird. They're like extreme right wingers. And it's like, they're doing, like, I was talking to, I think it was Jasmine St. Clair. Jasmine. Yeah. She did like gangbangs and stuff, and she is the most fucking based. We went to the bar afterwards, hung out, talked for hours. She's based out. I was like,
loves Trump and hates all the trans
stuff. So weird. Stuff. Yeah, yeah. It's kind of crazy. Like, there's this weird thing of like porn stars, and they're all like very like far right and based.
Well, porn's weird because, dude, it's like that documentary, and I hate to give Netflix credit, but it is one of the better documentaries. It's called Hot Girls Wanted, and basically it's about how all it takes to get these girls in is just put like a casting call, you know, like,
oh yeah,
like real actresses basically. And then they start emailing some guy like, hey, do you want to make $5,000 or something? Or, you know, and these are like usually desperate girls that don't have parents, don't have, you know, or if their parents are like, they don't like their parents or whatever. So they're just, you know, they're like very vulnerable young people that think that that's a lot of money and that's actually going to change their life or something. And I just don't know how it goes from that. And then you hear the girls that when they become the professional porn star, a lot of it's like because they like want to like tough it out to like almost like they almost do it when you hear after they get reformed. Like when I noticed in some of these documentaries that I've watched, because there's multiple documentaries like Life After Porn and stuff. I hear like this, not that I've seen so many, but I just noticed like a reoccurring theme is like they almost like kept doing porn to show like that they were tough. That makes sense. Like it's some weird thing like where they're like, I can do it all.
Oh, that they were
nothing will break me.
Yeah, right. I mean, yeah. The weird thing is it's becoming mainstream. Like regular girls are doing like hardcore shit on OnlyFans right now. Like I was saying, like I used
to, you know, Azalea, dude. I mean, and Isabella Riley dragged her. See, like this is why I cannot be like sympathetic to OnlyFans. It's not good because Iggy Azalea's on there now. All these younger kids are going to be on there. So I really got to kind of go hard on the OnlyFans.
It's not good. It's becoming so mainstream that like every other girl has it. There's normal girls, like a waitress or whatever. Oh, check out my. And it's like,
dude, they're you not go really... to the explore page on Instagram. You half the girls, like I'm just saying, I did a test just to look. Half the girls had a link to something in their link in bio. I'm like,
it's just normal.
This is like the OnlyFans recruit site or whatever.
It's nuts. Like I'm, you know, I look at like I've been obsessed with that whatever podcast show. All the clips.
Yeah, I know. They've been dominating, dude. I want to get on it. Dude, I got it. I want to
get the guy. Chrissy had the guy on the
Sovereign Bra. Yeah, Sovereign
Bra. Yeah. He was good. He you should get him on.
Yeah, I will. I'll definitely get the guy on. Yeah.
It's when these girls.
Whatever podcast.
I dated.
They have a YouTube page because like his clips are just going so viral now. He's so smart.
They got their own Twitter page with all the clips on it. So. I'm going to probably do a show one week where we just go through them and like just discuss what's happening because they're so good, the clips. But the when the girls talk about their like body counts, like these are just normal chicks, normal fucking chicks, triple digits. And it's like I dated strippers when I was in my 20s and they like normal girls were doing bigger numbers than like strippers were not strippers. 20 years ago, we're not as promiscuous as a normal chick is now. It's fucking crazy how
porn too. They've all watched the porn, so they all want to experiment sexually. And now we have this like where
that's it. The iPhone came out in 2006. It's like kids just have access to porn on in their hand at all times. And it's just lowered people like, but yeah, just like. Normal chicks that are, and they're just like, oh, I'm not that bad. I have like 30, 40. It's like, yo, these numbers are like, were pretty big for chicks back not too long ago. Those were big. 50 was like fucking, now it's like, girls are like, oh, I'm 23. I have 150. It's like, you're fucked in the head. They don't even understand how like damaging that is mentally. It's like you can't bond with that many people and like fuck it. But whatever, I'm an old fucking fart. But it's just, it's kind of a weird fucking world that's happened. Like like I said, I dated strippers who their body counts, and these were professional, you know, sex workers, and you know, they weren't as promiscuous as just a run of the mill chick is today, because they have fucking the apps. They could get fucked every night of the week.
Yeah. The apps. See, like they didn't have dating apps when I was in college. And that's what I noticed a big difference. Like in high school, I lost my virginity in high school, but I'm saying high school was like impossible to get laid. I mean, I did, I had a girlfriend, but in college it actually was pretty easy. So I think that like college culture has just come down to like high school basically. You know what I mean? Like, you know, like when you're like 18 and 19, you're like, some more sexually promiscuous now. That age is like probably 14 or 15 with these kids now. It's all gone downhill so fast.
It's great. Like I said, it kind of freaks me out when I see like just normal chicks that are like 21 and then their numbers are higher than like, I knew like strippers that did not, and they were like choosier. They had dudes chasing them. They were actually choosier. They were like fucking, you know, they fucked. They weren't like, these were no virgins, but it's like,
yeah, they were not virgins.
They were not fucking like at the rate of like, you know, where
the strippers, I think, used to be a better industry too. And there was less porn and less cell phones and it was more fun. Well, now, I mean, I'm sure women still make money with stripping, but it's not the same of that.
It was like, there's phases. It depends on the economy. In the late 90s, after the tech boom, like these girls in New York were making, you know, $2,000 a night. Those clubs would not let any of them give a hand job or do anything like that, because they were making hundreds of thousands of dollars a night. The club.
Like Howard Stern would have like the Scores guys. Those guys
were Lonnie. Running. Yeah. I knew Lonnie, and I knew like my uncles ran clubs in the city. Like, so I knew these people, but it's like, they wouldn't allow that shit because they do not want to get closed down because some girl's trying to make an extra $50 and now they're fucking closed for a week and lose fucking $500,000 in fucking, you know what I mean? It's like these places were clean. Like it was a lap dance. It was no touching. It was like that. So now, you know, now it's like girls are doing like
a brothel.
Because they're so fucking desensitized to shit. Like every girl's got an OnlyFans. It's pretty wild like how fucking quickly society has what's allowable. Like but nothing compares to what the fuck we were talking about before with the kids, where it's just like, yeah, it gives puberty blockers to your 5-year-old. Bobby likes the color pink. Oh well, quick, fucking sterilize him.
Somebody in the chat said I'm not wearing pants. No, I do not have pants, if anybody wants to know. I mean, I have underwear, but no pants. So.
Russell Hall for $2 says, where's Cecilia? Bring her to me now. Thank you, Russell. I'm sorry. I've been filibustering all over Alex here. And I have not been keeping up with the chat. Hold on. Russell Hall. Cecilia, he wants me to put on a wig. It's not that easy. I have to get into character. I have to take hormone blockers for a week.
This is a green wig. Now you can't see my head.
I guess it's green, right?
Yeah, it's green. What's up, guys?
Move over a little.
Brains out.
Move to the. Yeah. That looks good. Pilgrim Media says, let's do a jackass show with Cecil and Alex. We can do that. We got almost 1,100 people watching right now.
I know. What the heck? We got, come on, 1,100. Let's go, yo.
Oh, yeah. I'm supposed to say hit the like. Hit the fucking like, please. I'm not a really good
YouTuber. Notification bell. Hit it all, guys. Hit, we got a party, dog.
Subscribe. Like. Share. Argentico 2003, you say, was all that flirting with that porn star Chess to get Sheila back? I'll never say. I'm probably hanging out with her like next week. I was gonna hang out. I just was running around this week because I'm going to Chicago soon, so I have to get a shit ton of work done before I can go. So I haven't been keeping up with my porn stars to book on the show. But also, like, she wants her to come here to do the show, which is, I don't want her at my house. So I was going to probably rent a thing in the city to fucking do it from. But also, I can't do it like this because she will just take off her clothes. Like, I have to almost be there just to fucking stop her. Like, she's like
on the stream, she'll get naked.
Yeah. Yeah. She just
she was sitting there. Sex, dude. That's why she wants to come over. Does she have a boyfriend?
I don't know. Look, from
they all
the
have boyfriends, they all
on the looks of it, she has about six at a time.
That's what I'm saying. Does she do the gang? So she does the gangbang. Does she do the double anal and the double vaginal and all the?
Well, the first question and the chat knows this. I've already told this, but the first thing I said to her, she's like really small. She's like 100 pounds. I'm like, how the fuck did you fit two? I said, I don't mean to, but you're so. How did you fit two fucking cocks in your asshole? She goes, oh, I've had three. I was like, all right.
She's a triple anal? That's disgusting. Because that's what I saw a guy, and you're like, well, Alex, what do you know double anal is? I mean, you know, I've seen something. But my point is, when they ask a girl what's the hardest thing they've ever done, that's what they say, where two guys are in your beehole. Ugh.
But this girl is like, on another level. Like, she just started, like, we were sitting next to each other on the panel, and she just threw, like, her thigh over my thigh and started like masturbating in the middle of the show. Like,
and she was spread open on the show, on the table, on the kumi, on the compound table, or she was behind the chair.
She was beneath it. But they were playing her porn, and when she was watching it, it got her excited. And then, you know, she asked if I wanted to eat her butthole, and then that's when the volunteer came. He's like, I volunteer as tribute. He was like Katniss. He came running up and volunteered.
He was nose deep, dude, like 2 inches in there. Like, I mean, like, he was like a dehydrated guy that just found a bottle of water, like a coyote smuggling through the desert that got lost. And, you know, a sex trafficker finds a bottle of water and just pours it on him.
It was Oasis in the fucking desert for him, exactly. Just a kid from Brooklyn for $5. Thank you. I passed by Trump Tower on my way home from work today. There was a mob of reporters, cops, and Trump supporters on across the street. Total powder keg.
Yeah, nobody go and protest. Listen, I like Donald Trump. I mean, he obviously did some stuff that I don't agree with, you know, with the vaccine and this and that, you know, but do not go and protest. That's such a honeypot operation, or that's a deal where they're going to bring you in and they're going to January 6th you with a, you know, rope-a-dope, make you think you're doing something right, and then just totally frame job you, inside job you. I would definitely
John Mellon.
Do not protest.
Yeah. John Mellon, $4.99. I was depressed. Then I watched Tuesdays with Cecil. Now I'm suicidal. Thanks, Cecil. Or you could come in here. You have the link, John. You have the link. I always send John the link. John has.
You had a successful couple Tuesdays, dude. I mean, can you believe you got it? We got it to 11 hundo in the chat. I mean, guys, let's go. YouTube. Now, people, whenever you bring up the number, though, people want to leave. It's annoying. They're like, oh, I don't want to keep the number high.
Well, how many likes do we have? Can you see that?
617.
Come on, 1,000 people and only 600.
I know everybody should like it, but I mean, what the heck? What are you gonna do? I didn't even like it yet. I just liked it.
No, hold on, let me like
Coney Island Hospital put a dollar under your pillow and gave you a lollipop for a gunshot wound or stabbing because it was as common as a kid losing a tooth. The ER was like MASH. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, I told you, I worked in a hospital for a while, and I saw some fucking absolutely insane shit. I don't know if I've ever told this story, but. One kid, a kid, 12-year-old, got shot, right? And the doctors, they're taking him to the operating room. His hip blown apart, and they're gonna do like orthopedic surgery on him, basically. And they're like, well, you know, they got him IV going, but he's still talking. He's like out of it. And I remember the kid's name. I remember everything about this, like perfectly clear. And they asked the kid, what happened, Victor? You know, what happened? He's like, well, I kept getting mugged, and And then my mother bought me a pit bull because she's like, you can't leave the house without the pit bull. She's like, and then a car pulled up today and they shot me and they stole the pit bull.
Oh, you told me this one.
Dude, I told you this story. You got, like, hey, dude, everybody in the room just like looks at each other like, where the fuck are we, man? Like, yo.
For a dog. You're getting shot for a dog. Dude, for a
you can't leave the house without your pit bull. It's like car pulls up, shoots a 12-year-old and steals the fucking pit bull. Crazy shit was like going on like that in the 90s and fucking and that was in Brooklyn, actually.
So you do think New York is safer in that sense from the violent crime? It's just more of like the homeless drug.
It's coming back, and I think that the numbers are not as good as what you think because people aren't even bothering reporting. Like if I got mugged, I wouldn't even you know what I mean. I wouldn't even report it. Even if I got like hit over the head, I probably wouldn't report. You know what I mean? Like, what's the point? If they catch the guy,
well, this doesn't... I know that's true because think about how crazy Dontarius or Esteban, our buddy, dude, he has his asshole out in public everywhere. Like, I love Esty, but dude, that would not fly in Texas. Like, I could have him do a stunt temporarily, but like, dude, you can just be walking around, even our subway. There's like people on it. They'd be like, sir, you know, you can't just have your butthole out, you know?
No. He would, if back in Bloomberg or Giuliani days, he'd be fucking arrested and they'd fucking sit his ass in jail for about 5 days before they fucking got him in front of a judge. Especially
not that he deserves to be arrested. I want to make that clear because he's our friend. But actually,
if you do take your asshole out in front of a bunch of people on a train, you actually do deserve to be arrested. Not that I want him to be, but like, in a normal society, that's not. But in New York, that's not even.
Did you see his viral video? Like, everybody posted, and he did it before we even met. Where it's always they always repost it. Now they always send it to me. They always tag me on it. Where he grabs, it's a fake video where the guy's mopping the subway, and he grabs a bucket and shits in it.
That's like his probably most viral one. I think that's where
his most viral.
That's the one where all the kids. I think they probably know him from that. Remember all those kids were like, yay, this is the bomb, the bomb.
They all know him from that. And then he's done some wild ones where he's run on the train tracks and he's had some. And he had the super viral one where the girl's like, the best one is where she gets pregnant by him. Or she meets him on the street and she has like this story where she gets pregnant by him. That one got like 25 million views on TikTok or whatever. Dude, speaking of, dude, I had a video. So my girlfriend Paige, I just had her start. She's like, hey, I'll start posting your clips on TikTok because I had a TikTok and it just kept getting like strikes. So I stopped posting on it. Dude, this shows you how TikTok's so fake and how stuff can go viral. I had this video. Let me go to it. I just can't believe this. I'm not bragging because I'm not cool. But 1 million views. 1 million views today in one day. 1 million, if you guys can see that.
Hold on. Let me blow you up. What video was it?
This Uvalde video. 1 million.
Oh, yeah. That's the one where the people didn't go into the school, right?
Yes. And I went and called them out. Dude, I'm just saying 1 million views. Let me see if I can zoom in for you guys. Maybe that'll make it more. And I'm not trying to say brag, but it's like I've had it always so hard to go viral. And then what the heck, our fourth video gets 1 million? TikTok's fake. They do this to get you hooked to the Chinese dopamine receptor or something. How am I going to hit 1 million on my fourth video?
Nice. Yeah, but that's an awesome video. You know, every once in a while, Alex does a serious hard-hitting one, and that was, like, pretty fucking tough. If you want to, like, break it down for the people right now with the situation.
Oh, dude, the cops waited over 75 minutes to respond. And, dude, I just retweeted. I forget who posted it. It was such a great picture. It's from 2020, and it's the SWAT team of Uvalde. And, dude, it looks exactly like I was talking about the female pilot. It's just, like, some, like, overweight women, like, some kind of weird-looking guys. You know, some one or two guys look kind of tactical and serious. The rest of them look like mall cops. You know what I mean? Literally.
Yeah, they let the school shooting go on while they were, like, outside and
refusing to go in, refusing to go in. Why kids bled to death and died. They just said no. And then they're like outside, like putting on hand sanitizer and stuff outside in the hallway, putting on hand sanitizer. It's like, dude, they're more worried about COVID than they are a school shooter.
Yeah, that was pathetic. Yeah, Alex went there. That was not a joke video by Alex. He really went and called them out. Fuck it. in a way that they deserved. So yeah, I mean, I'm not surprised it got a million views. There's a lot of fucking people that are pissed about that. And
yeah, well, TikTok, yeah, that's my first million view TikTok. Now I'm kind of like into TikTok, I guess. Now now I'm addicted to it.
All right, hold on.
So they say never go to the casino and win. That's the worst thing. Cecil, have you ever gone to the casino and won money?
Yes.
Yeah, me too. And that's what's the worst thing you can do, because then you always feel like you can win.
I used to go to Vegas once a month for years, because I was with people who were whales, and they would sit, and I have no interest in gambling. I loved going to the clubs, to the shows, to the pools.
Hang out. Yeah, there's a lot to do.
My friends who got me there, who would be paying for it, basically they were gambling so much that we would give them sweets. The pit bosses would come over.
It's kind of weird. Well, I'm saying real quick, when I gambled, not that I had some high thing, they'd always want you to have like tickets for two. Like they always want you to bring somebody too. There's something weird about that with the gambling. So they just brought you. That's why, you know.
They saw me. Yeah, they saw me, the pit boss. Now this guy's gambling like crazy. And they'd hand me like fucking whatever, the Cirque du Soleil show tickets. This guy's not leaving the table. And they'd just be like, keep him here. Like yeah. They were like feeding me fucking free dinners. I'd go to Nobu. I'd go to fucking whatever. And they were just like, keep them here. And I'm getting all this motherfucker for 48 hours doesn't leave a table. Even when we go to the pool, he goes to the swim up thing and is fucking losing $600 a minute, you know, like fucking.
It's because you're an addict when you're like that. And then sometimes those guys catch a hot streak though, and they catch back up, you know, or something. So
I never caught the bug, right? And because I just never gambled. So I went to go see a comedy show at the casino in Connecticut with my ex-wife. And they hand you a $200 credit card, like free $200 for the slot.
Yeah.
So I was like, let's use it. She's like, let's go. It was after the show. She's like, let's go upstairs. I was like, so I go to the Indiana Jones one. And every time you pull up thing, it's like, dan, 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 dan. Like every time, like it gets in your brain, right? So fucking Dr. Jones, it's like all the sounds from the movie and different sounds mean hot. So within a few minutes, I'm up $800. You know what I mean? From a free thing. She's like, let's go. I'm like, I'm not leaving now. I got $800.
Yeah, we're out.
And then
yeah.
It was like, I think at one point I was up to I think 800 is the most I was up to. She's like, I'll meet you in the room. A few minutes later, I'm at 600. I was like, fuck, I should have just left at 8. Let me just get back to 8 and I'll leave. I get up there like 2 hours later. She's like, how much do you have? I was like, I lost 200. I ended up fucking putting money out of my.
Yeah, you went back to go get 200 more.
That was the only time in my life I ever gambled or even understood the addiction of it. Like, never gambled.
You invested because you lost that 800. So you're like, oh, this machine's going to hit. It's going to hit. It's this weird thing. You always think you're going to catch up. It's a weird mentality.
This shit ain't for me. But I would always go with these guys who would fucking literally gamble. Like, they didn't sleep. They gambled like fucking nonsense. They would lose 20,000 sometimes and they'd win 10 and they'd be like, yeah, I won 10 grand a weekend. It's like, you lost 20 the last time we were here. Like fucking, these guys were whales, you know? So I never understood the fucking mentality. And just from that, like, I don't know, hour and a half I spent in front of that slot machine, I was like, I'm never fucking with gambling, man. Cause that shit, like if I didn't know,
I've done it where I've lost like, you know, $2,000 in a night, but I've won like $2,000 in a night. So, I mean, I kind of gambled. I lived in Louisiana. So like randomly I would gamble, but now I'm just over it. I mean, I might make a sports bet or something, which I really don't very often, but I would, but gambling's just the worst, dude. It is. It's a no, because even when you win, the way a casino looks at it is a loan. They don't even care if you take a big win. They know you're going to come back because now in your head, you're like, I can win. The worst thing a gambler can do is actually win.
Well, that's why they do that with you on those street games, the ball and cup and the fucking three card Monty, is they hit you with the win. Did you see
that girl just lost $1,000 in playing three ball Monty on World Star Hip Hop? It just happened in Miami this weekend. Oh, I gotta find this video. Let me try to find it. It's really funny.
But we knew that since like we were little kids, you know, because they were all over the streets in New York, you know. But you'd see the tourists doing it because they'd make an easy one, you know, like they're all plants. If you walk by these people every day, you see, you can see all the people that they're with are like all the people that come over, like the strangers that come over to play are all part of the same team. And it's all just
play the video. Play the video I just sent you about that. I just sent it to your Twitter. It's exactly what you're talking about. They're all the same team. You can hear like this guy, he is like a teammate guy. And then like, I don't know.
It's for Taurus. Like they fucking, but I used to watch Taurus and then like, you know, it's every once in a while, somebody like a person from the city would just be like, yo, don't fuck with this. Walk away. And then like, you'd see people getting real mad at you, like in the faces in the crowd that are part of the fucking, they don't want like people fucking like, you're going to get fucked up now. If you start warning, you're like, all right, maybe I should move on.
Look at this video. It's hilarious. It's kind of sad to watch that too.
10K. Holy shit.
You just got to watch the video.
All right, hold on.
I don't know if it's that much. I mean, it looks like a lot. Maybe they're counting how much the guy had. I don't know. You just got to watch it.
All right, let me read John Mellon. John Mellon says, Blair is all woman to me. Well, except for her dick. Yeah.
Yeah. You want to remember the person. Remember the person filming this, too, is probably just. So this, him saying 10K, I don't know how credible of a news source this person is, all I'm saying.
They just lost 10K. That fast gambling in Miami.
Now, when she win that money, she can do whatever she wants.
Yeah, yeah.
It's in the middle
right now. Know what I
said?
Mean.
It's like it's
face up. Face up. Face all this shit up. You win 8,000.
Put it right here. Put it up. Give it here. I got it. This right there.
Which one you want?
This one.
You gotta let it go.
No, no, no.
How much? Hold up. Calm down.
I want that.
Calm down. I'll tell you, calm down because you're too high. You turn over. How much do you win? How much do you win?
No,
you turn over. How much do you win?
How much is that
one? $10,000. This is $10,000.
$10,000. Wait, can I get my I'm gonna bet all my money.
Oh, well, get your money back then. You ain't
bet.
This one on top. If you ain't
bet. Let me. How much I gotta bet?
I'm betting all of you. Must then see which one you want. Dilson. Which one you want? Bet all of
them.
Watch.
Which one you want? Dilson, which one you want right now?
It's
Push your bet up. Now you turn out. How much do you win?
$10,000.
The wrong one, how much do you lose?
It's the middle
one. Now you lose 10, you lose all your money.
Okay. I'm going to lose all of my money.
Yes.
Right there.
Get it, sis.
It's
get
right
it.
Right there. It's the
box.
It's
no.
Right.
No. Ah, they're wrong.
Yo, why are they fucking betting that much fucking money? Oh my god. You'd think those chicks would be a little more streetwise. Like, you know?
I know. How did she get that money? I mean, she's just obviously she didn't earn that because, like, if anybody had to work for $10,000, I don't think that'd look.
I have a feeling those chicks worked hard for, you know, one pipe at a time. But, like, you'd think those girls would be a little bit inside on the street hustles. Like, are you fucking kidding me? You're going to play fucking the ball and cup? Fucking game.
I know, like, what the Sprite cap and ball game? I mean, what on the felt thing? Like, oh my gosh, give me a break.
Yeah, that's fucking nuts. And let me tell you, those guys were not letting those girls walk away with 10. Like, it's a no lose for the guys. Once they got your money, you're not fucking like that guy would just take off. They know those girls are tourists.
Never going to see them again. Dude, yeah. Miami, did you see that video? Well, you can't play it. You get a strike. A guy's just walking in a crowd of people, just blows the guy's brains out and then shoots him 4 or 5 times. And he shot all like wildly. He's like in a group of people. He very easily could have shot somebody that had nothing to do with it. Not that I even knew what he had to do with it in the first place to shoot him. I'm just saying it's just so reckless. You're like, what? Like, how did more people not get hurt?
Yeah, I mean, I guess he was a good shot. I mean, that's the only thing I could say is he put center mass on his, it was some personal beef he had. It was probably another fucking drug deal or whatever the fuck it was. But the whole fucking Miami exploded. Like they were, the whole thing's under curfew because the whole, like there were like riots in the streets. It was fucking nuts. They used
to. I was saying, I love Miami, and I'm actually going in May, but I haven't, you know, I'm saying, I guess I'd always go to Fort Lauderdale. I haven't really spent much time in like that South Beach area. And now I hear it's like all black people that hang out kind of in that South Beach area right now. At least on spring break.
It depends what the week is. So what happened was they got sued because Miami used to have like the spring break, whatever the spring break was, would literally just be like, it would be all black and it would be like all like fucking.
There used to be a thing called Freak Nick. It was N-I-K, which was I'm not saying any bad word, where they would in like the 90s and 80s and then maybe early 2000s, maybe they still do it in Atlanta, where they would go crazy, though. If you guys can watch some viral videos, type in like old videos from that.
Here's what the guys did in Miami. All the hotels would do is they would do their renovation. A hotel has to do renovations where it's carpets or anything. And what they would do is because that week everything would get destroyed, they would close their hotel for the week and do their carpets, redo the beds, that would be their week for renovation. And then they sued and said, you're doing this for discriminatory. And then they wouldn't let them do it. So these hotels had to get.
Yeah, but why not do the renovation right after? I'm kind of mad at the hotel. If they're going to tear it up anyway, let them tear it up and then do the renovation right after. I get it.
Then also what they would do is South Beach, you know, is like a peninsula and you have to go over bridges to get to it. It's like almost an island. I think it's an island.
Yeah, a little island. It's a little island. Yeah, I'm very familiar.
And what they would do is after a certain part of the night, the bridges would go up. So no one could get fucking on it. Like, because it would turn into like riots.
So Miami would open and close the bridge. Wow. I didn't even think about
that. You had to be on South Beach by a certain time or you're not getting on it. Like,
oh, that's funny. The good old
but it was like starting to get bad in about by like 2003 starting to like, you know, just turn into complete fucking chaos with like the spring break weeks and shit. All the locals would leave town that week and be like, fuck this shit, man. So I haven't seen it like get wild like that in a long time, but yeah, this is fucking crazy. Especially Florida doesn't fuck around, and Miami-Dade police are fucking hardcore. They're corrupt, but they're also like fucking brutal.
No, they are. They're like arresting people for not wearing masks and stuff, I think.
Yeah, they're
pretty hardcore.
Jay Bama fan said, what's up, Jay? Give us your TikTok tranny impression. Oh, Jeffrey March. Jeffrey. Oh. Hey kids. No, he's always like, he's always trying to get like, if your parents.
This is how you disable parental blocker.
Yeah. It's like, I love you. If your parents don't understand you, that's why Jeffrey's here. It's so fucking creepy, man. That dude is like.
So scary. Do you think that many kids are watching it? I don't know. Like, is his audience that big?
And he tells like weird jokes. He's like, oh my God. I wanted to, I can't say. He's like, hey, I was washing my car with my friend the other day. And my friend said, why don't you use a sponge instead? I was like, the amount of violence that went through my body.
Dude, that guy is an actual creep. I mean, but did you see, so some Islamic woman came after him and then she got canceled?
You can't fucking, he's a holy person. You cannot fucking speak out against him.
Yeah.
Stormtrooper Julian Caesar says, Dylan gave me Mars Attacks vibes. A little bit. Yeah, the chick.
And I loved Mars Attacks. That movie was like nuts when it first came out. Jack Nicholson, everybody's in it. Do you think that movie's good? I think it's good.
I love objectively. The weird thing is, I didn't love it when it first came out, and now
it kind of was sad. When I was a kid, I remember watching it and being like, this is sad. Like, this is like not good. But now I love it.
Now I love
the dark humor of it.
Yeah. Now I dig it. If it's ever like on, I just jump on it. Or
A good ending. I'm just saying, I remember watching it and be like, oh, this is not. I don't know. I just was like, it was kind of like off-putting because I didn't really understand it.
It's so weird because it was based off of a card set, a Topps card set. Like, you remember when, like, Garbage Pail Kids?
Yeah.
Tops just did
That's where the aliens are from. Yeah, because it was like a script that had been written a bunch. What was the story? It was an old movie, then they rewrote it a bunch or something.
It was just based on, there was a card set that told a story of Mars attack, but it was like Garbage Pail Kids. It was like, it was just scenes from each card was a scene of a Martian attack. And it was called Mars Attacks. That was it. And fucking Tim Burton was like, I want to do a movie about those that card set. It was fucking really weird and pretty creative. But yeah, the more time that goes by, I really like it. Like, I don't know. I hated Jack Nicholson when I first saw that movie. I just hate it. Now I fucking love it. It's really weird, like how sometimes movies will change on you. Like your first impression was like, I didn't like this. And now it's like,
your perspective changes. Can you hear Sky Bear purring?
No.
Oh, maybe there's a noise. There's probably a noise gate on my microphone.
Wow, he's purring so loud. Just the love of a cat. So listen to this. My tortoise shell cat Dusty died.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I know, and I've been bummed out about it. But they say tortoise shells are good luck. Like the Japanese would always bring them on their battleships and stuff because they thought they were good luck. And I feel like my luck hasn't been as good. And so, dude, I might go get another cat. I have four and then bring it back to five.
You have four cats right now?
Yes, I had five. And I'm about to replace Dusty with another one. I'm about to get another. Dude, and these cats go pee outside the litter box. They get mad. They do so. I mean, it's insane, dude.
You also have no idea how chaotic it
is. I have a pit bull, too. A mean-ass pit bull that will bite your leg off. Dude, it's like a freaking zoo over here, dude.
Maybe hold off a little while on getting that fifth cat.
I know, that's what everybody's saying. Don't do it. But see, I feel like I need the good luck of the tortoise. You know what I
have to say to you is for everybody who has like the cat house, there is a certain cat piss odor that follows them. You don't have
everywhere.
It.
I got it. No, I literally.
I didn't notice it. I hung out with you a few times. I never caught a whiff of it.
My car the other day, my cat, I get the cat peed on a pair of my loafers or tennis shoes. And so I put them in the car. I got back in my car. I was like, oh my God, that car stunk. I was just sitting in the sun and it just peed on something I put in there. So that's how it chases you is Angus will go pee in the litter box, but randomly he like wants to go mark his territory on something. So he'll just like pee like a dime size. But dude, that stuff is like, I didn't smell my shoes until I got in the car and you realize that it gets hot. Like it can get reinvigorated. There can be dry cat pee. You can't smell it. And then it gets instant, you know, whatever it gets, activated is the word I'm thinking of. And then you can re-smell it again. So, you know, cat pee is a hell of a thing. And it's a freaking tough bird.
Are they all indoor cats?
Yes, they all sleep with me too, except for my mom, because my mom passed away, so I got her cats. I didn't plan on having this many, but now that Dusty's gone, dude, I think I need the fifth piece because I love, you know, I mean, I don't know, man.
It's hard to get past that. I didn't get a cat piss smell from you, but it's hard to get past that as a first impression when you meet somebody. If you smell like cat piss, that you're going to be known as that forever in their mind. Like
I know. And dude, honestly, though, I'm farting and shitting and sharding so much. I'd actually rather smell like the cat pee because if you're around me, as long as you don't smell the poop, any other scent's better than that. But, you know, I'm just saying, this is just me. I actually am so embarrassed. I was on a reality show years ago. Not embarrassed about the reality show at all. I mean, I should be, but I'm not. But I did an interview after on the Today Show. My one time that I was on the Today Show with Hoda and Kathy Lee, and I'm sitting there, and there's another guy that like loved cats that was on the show. And on the show, I made fun of him. I was like, this is a cat guy. And now I'm a cat guy. I literally rescue cats. Like, all I want to do is rescue cats. So it's weird. See, like you said, your movie taste changes, your whole life outlook changes.
Bacon says it's colder in Austin than in New York right now.
It's cold in Dallas, dude. It's been freezing. I don't have my watch on, it's on the charger, but. Dude,
did you go to Southwest?
I did. I had a comedy show. I didn't go to any of those events, but I had a comedy show one night down there. It was really good. There's like 70 people. I sold 70 tickets, and I with like a month notice. I should have publicized it more. But no, dude, it was a blast. I had a show at Vulcan Gas where Rogan was doing all of his shows, but then he opened his comedy club next door.
Yeah.
And then I have a show. Yeah, and I'm going back April 14th. I got a show with Alex Jones and Tim Pool. At Vulcan on stage, they're doing a live Timcast.
Mr. Biggins right here invited me. He's from over there, and he invited me to. He got tickets for Rogan's comedy show on Saturday, just passed.
He told me
Thursday night.
Every weekend that he's in town now, probably.
He told me Thursday night. I'm gonna go another time. Because South by Southwest was going on, the fucking flights were fucking insane. Plus, I got to do a lot of shit.
Oh, ridiculous!
I got to get a ton of stuff done. Dave McFarlane, $5. Thank you, sir. Our world is taking crazy pills. Yeah, for fucking real, man. It's hard. You know what? You're going to have to go down that avenue with this OnlyFans chick. I guess you would have to. I wouldn't, because to me, I'm like, you're an adult. You're an adult. There's going to be consequences to it. Is that like, you know, you know, some guys will be fine with it, I guess, you know, but other guys will just be like, you know, I'm not fucking investing in a chick that like the gas station attendant can see your pussy for $3.
Yeah, I would never date a girl with an OnlyFans. I mean, literally, that's non-negotiable. Like,
oh, I would.
Even if she had an OnlyFans and closed it down, I knew her after, I'd have a problem with that.
I would. But I'm never getting married again or anything. So, like, to me, I don't care. Like, do whatever you want.
Yeah. I just still, I mean, you know who hates me right now is Destiny. You're familiar with Destiny, right?
Yeah.
The streamer.
Why?
And he's so mad. He like was talking about me the other day on a stream, and I've apologized to him, like trying to get, you know, water under a bridge or whatever the cliche you want to use. And he's so mad because I call him out. I was like, he thinks I'm a degenerate, and I'm like, he gets mad that I call his wife out for being in an open relationship. Like, he gets so mad at me for calling him out. He gets more mad at me than he does the guys that are having sex with his wife. He gets more mad at me for talking about how his wife sleeps with other men than his wife actually sleeping with other men.
All right, that's weird. That's one thing that's like, I don't know. Like, to me, it's like I've dated strippers and a fucking, you know, I wouldn't care, but a guy like your girlfriend or wife going out and fucking another dude, like that's just doesn't make any sense to me. Like that doesn't make any fucking sense. That's not
what's
a girlfriend. That's not.
Well, yeah. What's the point? That's what I'm saying.
I'm just like, what the fuck is the point? Exactly.
If that's what the other person wants, they want to have sex with other people, then no, we're not going to be in a relationship. It's just not. It's just not. That's not going to fly with me. And I don't know why it flies with other people. And like, she's really hot. And like, these other guys are banging your wife. Like, I mean, just no, it's just not. There's no, it's not okay.
I don't know. Also, don't you look like a fucking idiot? Like, what the fuck? Like,
yeah, guys.
You know what? What are you apologizing for? Fuck that asshole, man.
No, but I just try to be like, hey, look, I won't even keep bringing it up, but it's just weird.
He's right. He's more mad at you than the dude's banging his wife. Like, fuck that shit. Fuck him.
Yeah.
Russell Hall for $2. Speaking of licking butt, whatever happened to Anna? I don't know. I haven't heard from Anna in a while. She went upstate to visit her boyfriend's family. I think they're up there.
What is she not? Is she not doing the jack show or something? Or did she?
No. The last time I spoke to her was Thursday.
They all want to know where Anna is, dude. They all want to know. She's so upset about 9/11. Is there an inside joke about that?
Where does it say? Oh, because she gave me a calendar, like, and she personalized it. And for November, she's like, I forget what she said. Oh, it's Thanksgiving and also the anniversary of 9/11. And she thought September 11th was in November. And I showed it on it. I showed it on air and made fun of her, and she kind of, I think she left the show and she got mad. But like, how are you
11/9?
No, I don't know why she thought, maybe because the 11? I don't know. You know, you got to remember she was like 4 when it happened. So like, whatever. But yeah, she wrote this whole thing calling me a fat fag and everything. And then she's like, you're going to gain weight. And it's sad because 9/11 is sad. And this month is 9/11. And we're reading this and I'm just like, do you think fucking 9/11 is in November? And I'm like,
and what did she say?
She started saying something about, I don't know. I was very drunk, so I don't really remember.
She didn't know that it's September 11th.
I don't know, but you know,
Anna, we need to, I gotta have her on my show. I need to ask her. Like, this is gonna be investigated.
Probably gonna be pissed about me just talking about it now, but the chat is asking about it. But yeah, so listen, we roast the shit
actually,
out of
her. Actually, I applaud her, and I'm not just saying this to White Knight, that she's like not all caught up in 9/11, that she didn't even know all the rigmarole, because I know every single thing about it. Like, you know, and then I had Mike Baker on, the CIA guy that always goes on Rogan's show, and he was such an establishment, like, you know, talking points. Oh, everything was as it seems. Like, and it just made me so mad. I wanted to just yell at him, but I'm like, oh, I invited him on my show. I'll be respectful. But dude, I'm happy that Anna is not like even caught up in the drama of,
she does not know
what 9/11 is.
She does not know, you know, who her senators are. Like, she knows the whole council of Jedis. She knows, you know, the Senate council on Alderaan. She knows, you know, the Federation's high command. She knows the Klingon high command. She don't know who the fuck Nancy Pelosi is. So she's in, this is totally on brand for her. Like, this is you can't rip her apart that much, because this is not like out of character her, except that the fucking holiday. I wouldn't call it a holiday, but except that the event's name is September 11th. You know, unless she never put together that 9/11 is September 11th. Like, I don't know. But like,
because there are always people like, oh, it got attacked at 9 a.m. Like, do you think that's what she thought it was? And then
I don't know. I didn't get to have a talk with her about it. She gets, you know, when Anna gets angry, I just like kind of like let it go, you know, whatever. But yeah, I think she was upset that we were goofing on her, but we roast the fuck out of each other on that show. And if you think you're going to say September 11th was in November and that's going to get a pass, like, it's not going to happen. You're going to get roasted.
No, dude, I need to kind of ask her. I need to investigate. Yeah. I need to make her like do a little study session, I guess. And kind of learn about 9/11. She needs to learn a little bit. Like, I actually applaud her, because they say ignorance is bliss. And like, you just went through the whole roster of like fictional characters she knows, but she probably should know a little bit about 9/11, honestly. Maybe a little bit, you know.
Well, the biggest 9/11 in her life was September 6th, so I understand that.
Why was September 6th?
January 6th. January 6th.
That's a
10 times worse than 9/11, so that's probably
They say. And dude, they were able 2 hours after it reconvene and still certify the election.
Russell Hull, don't become another network cuck, Alex. And John Malin, he's talking about the blonde chick there that we had up. John says he forgives her too for doing OnlyFans. Bob Newhart would smash her. I'm sure she's swooning right now. Alex needs some Biggins lessons. You should meet up with Biggins. The next time you're in Austin, this guy is a trip, man. I think you guys would get along.
I'll be there in 2 weeks, and then I'll be there in May too. Nina Infinity, tell Alex to ask her about her thoughts on Israel and Palestine. Oh my gosh, I'm sure she knows all about the conflict in Israel and Palestine. That's
Anna.
Yeah,
you're like, what, they're mad at each other. No, there's no fucking way.
She has no idea.
Yeah, but like I said, like, you can't, like, it's not like she's ever, you know, sold herself as some sort of like political pundit, like quite the opposite. So, but yeah, like I said, this is like now crossing the line into like,
oh, speaking of Anna, dude. So did you see Kevin Smith? I watched this like a 10-minute clip where this guy that's like a huge Kevin Smith fan, Kevin Smith's like going through an existential crisis. He had to quit smoking weed recently. Did you see this?
No.
Yeah, so as he's freaking out, he had to go to like a 30-day rehab and quit smoking weed. Wow. So Anna doesn't know. Yes, I don't know. He talks about it in his like audio-only morning show. This guy that's like a huge stan, he's like, oh, I'm so happy that he's not smoking weed, because supposedly the story with Kevin Smith is that he never smoked weed. He did Clerks and, a sleeper movie, a huge hit for what he spent on it, like kind of put him on the stratosphere. And gosh, I forget what movie. He worked on a movie with like some famous actor and then smoked weed for the first time, and then he was done. Now, then he became a huge pothead. And that's why they say like all of his movies have sucked. This one guy that's a huge Kevin Smith fan.
Gosh, I forget Jason Mewes, I think, is a huge pothead. That's his partner, basically.
I mean, the stoner, but I don't know. I don't know if they... You got to hear the podcast. It wasn't him. It wasn't Jason that gave him weed for the first time. Because I don't think that Jason guy smokes weed. Jason Mewes or whatever. I think he's like kind of like like straight laced a little. Not,
who the fuck? Oh, he did a movie with Seth Rogen.
Oh, Jason Mewes is a heroin addict. Oh, wow, that's not sad. Okay, well, it was Seth Rogen. It was Seth. That's the story. He does it with Seth Rogen and Zach and Mary, and then he gets addicted to weed. And but he would like defend it. He would never say he was addicted. And as a matter of fact, like there's because Joe, I mean Joe Rogan, even though he podcasts a lot, because Kevin Smith podcasts a lot and stuff. This guy that's like a huge fan, like went back and was playing clips of how like Kevin Smith is in these podcasts with his writing partners, and they're like, "Yeah, Kevin, you should smoke less weed." And then like Kevin has this really crazy, goes on this rant. It's like, if it wasn't for weed, you wouldn't have a job, because when I lost my job and I was worried about you losing your job, it was the weed that made me. He's like, "Hey, we should take care of everybody." And the guy's like, "No, it wasn't the weed. It's not why you saved us." And yada yada yada. It was just he. And this is in his like heyday of smoking weed. Like just had the most epic cope of why I needed to smoke weed. And this guy was playing this clips, this fan, like I keep going back to the super fan who had a YouTube channel. I would like to shout it out, but I don't know it. But he's like, I can't wait to see what Kevin Smith without weed is. So this is some new era where he had to quit.
Somebody defending weed, I don't give a fuck what it is. Whatever your drug of choice is, that person, when you bash that drug, they will defend it like it's their child. Like, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, they'd be like, you don't understand. I do coke because I'm
that's
drinking.
That's the drug. No, yeah, yeah, Cecil, that's the drug. It's like with Xanax or it's like coke. Like these people, like even when they have success, like they like the drug is in their mind. They can't imagine their success without that drug too. See what I'm saying? Like Whitney Houston had all the success in the world, but like she like defended her drug use and coke and all this stuff because it's the coke and the drugs that are talking right in your head.
But it's like, yeah, if you badmouth pot to a daily pot smoker, or you badmouth coke to a guy who's like, you know, fucking,
it's not bad. It's not
like you don't know. You drink, right? But then like this like wakes me up, so I'm not as drunk and blah blah blah, and then I get a lot done the next day. I don't have a hangover. Like they're defending this shit. Like they got a whole defense for whatever the fuck. It could be any drug, whatever that drug of choice is. People will. I used to defend like.
Braden, wait. Braden Dykstra just said my drug of choice is cats. You're right, Braden. I just sit here with a cat.
Oh, remember on South Park where they were doing cat piss?
No, that was the drug. It was actually cat piss.
Yes, that, there's a real episode where they're all doing cat piss, and they hallucinate from it. I think that's your drug, man. Student of God says, Alex, content idea. Do what is Comicsgate? What is
Comicsgate?
Comicsgate is
Comicsgate the camera.
Is when people started complaining. It was like a fan movement when Marvel and DC started getting woke. And and then
was Gamergate? Explain Gamergate to me again. I know Ethan Ralph, and that was because gamers were being too sexual. They were sexual.
I'm gonna get tweeted up for not explaining Comicsgate better than that. But basically, people started making their own comics to compete with Marvel and DC, and just doing it like I did. But then a bunch of guys who got, you know, Ethan Van Sciver got blacklisted from DC basically, and you know, because he voted for Trump. And you can't be an open Republican and work for DC Comics, even though he was one of the most popular fucking artists there. And then he came over to Comicsgate early on, and you know, he's a good broadcaster. You've been on the show with him with us, so he's really good, and he fucking blew everything up. But they started calling us Comicsgate as like a slur, like Gamersgate. Gamergate was where.
Yeah, I know the games. Yeah, like yeah. They were like, you know, too chauvinist.
It's just woke getting injected into something where it doesn't belong. I mean, fucking American comics, Marvel and DC are dead, completely dead. Every character at DC is gay. That's their only idea. It's like, let's make them gay. So it's like Robin's gay, Superboy's gay. Like everybody's fucking gay. Like they
Superboy. Yeah, because it's not Superman. Yeah, it's his.
Well, actually, he became Superman because Clark left the planet or some shit. So he became. So for a while, Superman was gay. Well, guess what happened? The fucking sales went through the floor because for some reason there wasn't an outcry for fucking gay Superman. So Superman was gay for a while and fucking, you know, and they just canceled Robin. They made Robin gay. And. a character that's been around for decades, has girlfriends, all of a sudden they're just like, let's make him gay one day. Okay, he's gay now. Like, it's just, it's an insult to the fans. It's fucking, it doesn't respect the source material, and people just tune out. And the Japanese are putting out fucking manga that people love, and they're not injecting all the woke bullshit into it. So it's dominating. I mean, like, not even close. So that's what happened.
Dude, we're almost at 1,200 people. Can you believe that, dude? On a freaking, I can't believe you beat my, I think you beat my show maybe tonight. Gosh, dude, you're in just insane for the Ukraine, Cecil. This is what
you're here, man. You just,
no, you just turn it on. Oh, I see Vinny's mom has Scientology. She actually invented that. And people are saying, dude, I am tired, dude. How long are you going to stream tonight? We're almost at 2 hours. I got to go soon. I'm dying out here.
Let's wrap it up in a few minutes, or you're welcome to leave, and I'll read some.
No. I want to hang out. I want to wrap it up. I'm just saying, if you,
I'll go for. Let's go 20 minutes. Let's end it at midnight here. How about that?
Oh yeah, that works. That works. No, that's cool. Have you noticed though that I've been coughing, dude? I got like, I don't feel sick, but I got some sort of.
Maybe allergic to cats.
No, it's not that. I'm not allergic to freaking cats.
Wait, are you able to let them outside, or you just wouldn't do that?
I just don't. I mean, one of the cats I do, but then he goes and chases this other black cat, and then I'd like get nervous. So, dude, I feel guilty. I do want to let one of them out, and really two of them like to go out. But sometimes I take him in my backyard. I take him outside of my backyard, but I don't like let him out.
But so you're in a house, not a...
Yeah, no, I'm in a house. I'm gonna pimp on a blam, man. It's a duplex, actually. I say a house, but yeah, I mean, it's half of a house. But yes, it's a big half.
So just let them out, man. Like that. Like I've had cats and dogs, during my marriage, but all the cats were outdoor cats. They would just go out. So they never pissed anyway. In fact, they barely ever use the litter box because.
Yeah, because they would go outside. The cats prefer to go outside. That's what I'm saying. The one cat that, like, if I don't let it out, it'll, like, go pee in the kitchen near the door.
That's what I'm saying. Let them out. Yeah. Then you have, like, it's the best part of cats. They come in, they hang out with you, but then you have
but I love them so much. So if anything happened to my baby kitty, I would go insane. Yeah,
what are you talking about? If anything happens to them, they give them away for free.
I know. I've been actually looking about getting another one, dude. There's too many to choose from. I'm like getting too distracted, but I'm like, oh my gosh, I want to save them all. And that's what I'm going to do. See, so when I do blow up like the World Trade Center, when it is primetime 99 and I'm the next freaking, whatever, Jimmy Fallon or something, if that happens, I'm putting all my money in cat rescue. I don't care about it. I don't care about the house. I don't care. I mean, I'll buy myself a nice truck or something. I'm going full cat rescue. Legacy.
The you're pussy getting a truck palace. So you get more cats in it. That's why you're getting a big truck.
Exactly. I want a truck so I can freaking tow some cats. Have a cat trailer in the back.
Oh my god! Yo, you gotta get like a nice ranch, and you can let them all outside.
Major choke out. It's not gay to love cats. Cats are actually the most masculine thing you can do. I'm so straight that I can love on a cat, and no, and I still got I still got the poo nanny on lockdown, dog.
Craft 75, cats are gay. Cats Craft 75. Hey, it's Alex Stein's wife's boyfriend's butler and Alex Stein primetime 99. Yes, Cecil and Alex and Don Terrius, keep it up. Absolutely.
I'm are Don Terrius's valet in a weird way. You kind of did help him out.
I did have to get his clothes while he was
Dude, remember when he got his clothes out of the elevator and then, dude, just him at that McDonald's and then he drinks that milkshake and he was like, because I bought him the milkshake unsolicited. And like, had I known that he had lactose intolerance, dude, he farted all night, man.
Until he just left in the middle of the night.
To do what? To do God knows what? You know.
Nobody knows.
He was so serious. He's like, are we going to get some hookers? I thought he was kidding. But then, like, when I saw his face, he was dead serious. He thought we were not going to get hookers, I think.
All right. Here's how crazy Don Terrius is. Okay, he dresses in rags and everything. He didn't bring a change of clothes so we could go anywhere.
No. No extra pair of pants.
Nothing. So the only thing he went to another state. He took a bus ride in the bum uniform. He could have easily, so we couldn't even go to like a good restaurant
Eat at any restaurant other than McDonald's.
We went to the buffet. We went to the buffet and everybody there thought we brought a homeless person in and was feeding him like, you know, like we were doing a good deed. So they were being like nice to Alex and stuff because it's like, oh, look how nice these guys are. They're sitting at a table with a bum. And this guy's like, this motherfucker literally traveled in rags. He didn't have to travel in rags. Like he could have put the costume on and off, but he's fucking. So here's the thing. He did leave the apartment or the hotel at 4 a.m. for hours. He just disappeared, right?
Yeah,
but he went out dressed like a bum, so he could have got arrested. But and also we think he went out for prostitutes, but what prostitute is gonna like let him go near it? He looks like the fucking filthiest bum in the world.
Like, trust me, there's a prostitute that would let him get near that. There's a prostitutes don't get to be like, no, sir. They kind of have to say, I mean, it's not,
I don't know.
I'm not a like, prostitute expert, but I think the ones he gets with, I don't think they care. I mean, about Don Terry's and where
I mean,
they don't have pants on either.
He's in rags, though, literally going up, like, you know what I mean? Like, if there is a limit that they have, I think that would be it. Like, literally, this dude looks like he was shipwrecked.
Dude, his butthole is hanging out. I mean, literally, like, he's walking, you're seeing his ass crack. And I am, will I come to San Francisco? I saw that earlier. I'm coming to San Francisco on Friday. I'll be there the 24th. I'm speaking, and I'll actually be there Friday and Saturday. I'm staying an extra day, which I'm kind of nervous about now because I just saw a video of, like, 25 kids beating up an older man inside of a Target in San Francisco. So I was staying an extra day because I was planning on getting some content, maybe going and filming some of the homeless people, but now I'm worried I might not make it out alive.
You want me to come with you?
Yeah, you need to come. I'll be there this weekend. Dude, it's going to be wild. The flights are probably cheap to San Francisco to New York because nobody's going either way.
I think I'm
going to
be in Dallas when
this weekend?
No. We spoke about it a couple weeks ago.
Okay. All right. I'm going to be in town then, right?
Yeah. You wanted me to come by the studio, man.
I want you to come on the show. Oh, yeah, with Christy. Yeah. Yes. What is that, though? Yeah, but when is that? Or you don't want to tell? You tell me off stream. You can tell me off stream.
Okay, yeah.
For secretive purposes only. But, dude, I can't believe we had like 1,200 people watching your stream. That's really – and I'm not just keep sit here and keep talking about that. But, dude, that is really strong to all the people in the chat and all the super chatters. Dude, you did really well, especially a couple 50-piece McNuggets guys. And if you guys want to leave a super chat, we're about to end the stream here in a minute. So, you know, get in before you can, Alex. Support while
Pilgrim Media for two. Thank you, Alex. Pilgrim Media for $2. Cecil, I quit in Vegas for them getting in my way.
Stripping? Oh, gambling? I don't know.
Gambling. You know what I did? What I would do is I would do drive-by roulette. Like if I had time to kill. I would throw like a 20, a 50 or something.
Yeah, and that's just more fun. Yeah.
And I was like, but I would not sit there for hours. And here's the other thing. A few times I hit like big money. I have a story where fucking I threw down like 100 and fucking hit. And the whole table fucking, when they saw me throw it, I had a turban on my head. I was so drunk that one of my friends took a pink ball from this girl. I just got married. Fucking, so I'm in a tuxedo with a fucking pink turban on my head.
This on your wedding night that you did?
My wedding night. Wow, and I'm fucking, I'm wasted. I'm on ecstasy. I'm fucking drunk. I throw down. Yeah, I got married in Vegas. Fucking, it's like a moron.
Why not? I don't hate on that. That's the most cliche place. I would like to get there. That'd be fun.
So I walk over a table with a fucking turban on my head. And I forget the turban's on my head. My friend just wrapped it on my head while we were sitting. Fucking, now I go to take a piss. I'm walking across the fucking casino. And I just grab $100 bill out of my pocket, walk up to the table, and I play the date, the date, because I just got married. The whole fucking table looks at me. Now, I don't even realize I have the fucking turban on my head. They all start fucking piling onto 14. Fucking, they spin it, it hits. Fucking place erupts. Everybody's going, this one guy grabs me, goes, I knew it! The Swami knew! And I don't even know what the fuck he's talking about. Except I got a piss so bad, so I'm like, I'm cashing out. I just took all the chips. I took the chips, and the dealer was just like, what the fuck is that? You hit, and you, like, no one does that. Like, but I had a pee so bad. I walk into the bathroom, and the first thing I see is myself in the fucking mirror with this thing on. I've been walking around a casino with a fucking turban on. I fucking rip it off. I'm like, oh, my God, no wonder they all fucking, this weirdo, weirdo comes over, puts $100 fucking bet, like, out of the blue. Like, I like, squeeze in to do it. Like, yeah, it was, but, like, yeah, that doesn't give me the bug. Like, I just went right back out. We partied. We went to a strip club and fucking, yeah, it was, we just partied. Like, I just don't want to sit gambling, man.
When you hit and run like that, yeah, that's fine. Like, you play, like, one thing. I was in Vegas the night Tupac was shot. Wow, Pilgrim. What the heck, dude? That's legendary.
We need you for questioning now. Don't leave town, Pilgrim. Uh-oh.
Well, and that just shows you, you know they know who killed Tupac and Biggie, dude. Yeah, right.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Did my internet die? No, I can hear you.
My screen is frozen. It, like, got the white cloud.
Yeah, so, it can still me. So maybe I'm carrying it. So we're still online. I can hear you. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is the Primetime 99 Alex Stein and Cecil Show Tuesday night. You're going to get it at 8:30 p.m. Central Time, 9:30 Eastern. You're going to get a wild 2 hours, maybe even more, of content, shooting the shite, sitting back, chewing the fat. And if you guys want to support me, make sure to go to the description. You're going to see a little page for Primetime with Alex Stein. Yeah, I'm starting to see you. You're coming back to life a little bit.
What the fuck is going on over here?
It's starting to catch up a little.
Dark forces are working. Right. Yeah, but is
now
the stream
you're working? Now you're going. Yeah, the stream is still up.
There we go. Good. All right, we're good. There we go. Well,
yeah, we're still kicking with gasoline.
Can they hear us though?
Yes, they can hear you. They can hear you.
My God,
we can see you. Restart your browser, Cecil. We're still here. Restart your browser, Cecil. Restart your browser.
All right, I'm
probably right though. Okay, you know, you can really crowdsource a lot of stuff by people in the chat. You know, I listened to James O'Keefe talk about it, and then I had a meeting with him. I'm not going to say too much other than that. Actually, I'm not going to say anything. I never had a meeting with James O'Keefe.
Scratch that. Is he investigating you? When you had the meeting, did you know you were having a meeting, or was he undercover?
It was some hot girl with big tits, and she ripped off the titties, and it was James O'Keefe underneath, just a guy with his wiener out. It was disgusting. So I hate that guy.
Real Cecil voice, sweet puss. I don't know. I'm trying to catch up in the chat. Let me get to the bottom. I don't want to miss any super chats. But yeah, I don't know.
Tonight. You guys have been firing them off. You guys have been supporting.
Yo, critical orc theory for $5. Thank you, sir. I assure you that despite the corruption caravan derailment, that it's perfectly safe to return to East Goblinstein Mordor. Yeah. I don't know what Troy was doing drinking water in fucking Ohio.
Dude, you got to look it up. Troy freaking, our buddy Troy had a cup. Like, the water's safe. Doing the old like
pouring it on his shoulder, like he's sick.
Yeah, it just it's so good. It just pours.
That's good water.
Now that would have gone viral for real, but it actually went viral on like a real sense because people are like hating on it. Like, look at this. There's no way.
Seems a little shilly. I mean, I like the guy, but I mean, it seems.
Yeah,
it'd be funny if you see him like doing it, and it's like pours on it, like. He's doing that to the side thing, and it's pours, and you see smoke coming off his jacket. It's eating away at the jacket.
Yeah, it's burning his skin. Well, a Norfolk Southern, trust me, they can donate to a political campaign just like anybody else.
Stephen Cooper for $5. Aloha snack bar people are also nice pussy. I think he's saying
Allah Akbar.
Yeah, I think he means like. Persian chicks, but which is true. I think he's. I don't know. I don't know about Afghani. I'm not sure. Urashima Otaru says Destiny's getting mad at you, Alex. It's called copium.
A little bit. I mean, he's kind of coping. He's like making me out to be the bad guy for just saying, "Hey, other guys bang your wife. That's probably not good." And he gets more mad at me than the guys that are doing it. Like, if he actually was cool with it, he was just like, oh, I'm too cool for school. I don't care. My girl can do whatever she wants. Then me saying that should be much less triggering than her actually doing sex with another person. So,
isn't it kind of weird? There's been like a fucking rash of dudes that are doing this, right? Like, wasn't that guy Sneeko? You know who that is? I don't know.
I watched that whole clip, and I kind of like Sneeko. Like, he's following me. Like, I'd like to have Sneeko on my show. But, dude, yeah, I saw that clip where I watched it the other day, as a matter of fact, because he had Aiden Ross on. It went viral. And, dude, I was really not impressed with that statement. He was like, yeah, I just watched my girl get banged at this sex club. And the way he described it, he's like, I was in a war. It felt like war. It was so terrible. But then he goes on to be like, oh, yeah, it was a good thing. Everybody should do it. So I'm like, what, dude? You're describing it as, like, literally a battlefield. You don't know what's going on. Yeah, you're, like, scared to death. And the next thing you're, like, telling people to do it. Just, I would ask him why.
This is like a YouTuber thing? Like, you got the Jack Murphy. Then you got fucking Destiny. Then you got Sneeko. Like, this is a lot of people that are fucking... Are we out of touch?
I mean, I guess. I don't know. I mean, I just thought that's the whole point of dating, is that you're kind of monogamous. I mean, that's just what it is. I don't even... Maybe I'm old-fashioned, but I don't think cheating is right. I don't think people should cheat on each other. Like, no. I don't cheat. I'm not going to cheat on someone.
I don't either.
That's bad. I mean, yeah.
If you're in a relationship where someone's cheating, like, what's the point? Like, it's the same thing as that. It's almost like saying, yeah, I let my fucking girlfriend fuck. It's the same thing. But it's like, oh, she's cheating, but you didn't break up with her, so it's like the fuck. Like, I don't get it. Like, people, I think people are just fucking. I like the person was saying before.
It's mental gymnastics to, like, justify it, and I guess he just likes her, and maybe he feels comfortable with her, and so he'll take those bad things. But for him to act like it's a good thing, or that he doesn't care, that he's, like, getting so much side pussy that it makes it worth it. There's no way. There's no amount of side girls that would make it worth the girl you really love getting banged by other guys.
Yeah. And also, like, if you're fucking a girl correctly, she's not looking for it elsewhere. Like, you know what I mean? It's just, it's weird. I don't know.
Yeah, because then she's, like, talking to him. Like, I mean, the sex is disgusting. That's the worst thing. But it's also bad if she's having an emotional affair. She's texting him and stuff. Like, that's, like, just as bad almost.
Yeah, it's fucking weird, man. But I mean, I don't know. Like, everything in society is getting, like just, like I said, that's a lot of fucking YouTubers for three. Like, I can name three right off the bat who watch their fucking girlfriends get fucked. It's like, what the fuck is that all about? Like,
and Jack Murphy was like sticking stuff up his butt on that chat, Chatterbait or whatever that site. Like, dude, what? He was.
I only had another guy here that was trying to get into ComicsGate who was. Had somebody, Sheila Aliens, uncovered his Pornhub account where he was getting things shoved up his ass too by his ex-wife. And it's like, what the fuck is going on out there,
man? No, everybody needs to get pegged. Everybody's got to, I mean, whatever happened to just old missionary sex is enough. I mean,
I don't know. Maybe we're, like I said, maybe we're out of touch. Anna made Kevin Smith cry. That is true.
Yeah, she did make it. He seems like he's kind of emotionally unstable, though, from the way this guy is, like, well, I know, but the way this guy described him, like, his fan, I don't know, he had, like, a fan's perspective, but even he was like, I love him and he is talented. And probably Kevin Smith objectively is probably a talented director and probably has, like, funny ideas. Like, I know his latest stuff sucks or whatever. I'm not even trying to, like, white knight for that, but let's just say, like, objectively, he's, you know, knows what he's doing when it comes to, like,
probably,
you know.
Sucks because if he's a pothead and he thinks bad ideas are good ideas. It's also why Seth Rogen honestly has been in a fucking, his shit has been garbage for fucking,
exactly.
It's the same thing.
He sucks, but dude, there was a time when he was good. There was a time when Seth Rogen was freaking hilarious. You know, 40-year-old spoke
so much shit that you can't tell the difference between good ideas and bad ideas. That's the fucking problem. And it's happened to Kevin Smith. Like, he was able to say, this is good, that's bad. Now you're high all the time. You're like, that's good. Everything's a green light. You know what I mean? You're not discerning when you're fucking high. So you think bad ideas are just fucking great ideas.
Yeah, that's what the guy said. That I keep bringing up this guy that was his fan. He's like, yeah, some of the questionable decisions he made in Clerks 3 and stuff, you know, some of the questionable decisions he made, like, now that makes sense. You know, like, why would he do this in the movie? Why would he use this plot point? Why do yada yada yada? So I don't know, maybe he'll get clean and maybe he'll get a little more based. I don't know, but I don't have a lot of hope for him. But why does Kevin Smith suck so bad again? Just because he's like become like a cuck, kind of liberal cuck. Is that why he's so bad?
Yeah, he also did, like, he got woke. You know what I mean? He got very woke and he's very fucking into, like, identity politics and the whole fucking agenda. And it's just like, dude, look at how far you've come from like the original Clerks, where it was just like, they almost wanted to give it rated X and it had no nudity in it because of the dialogue was so filthy. Like at that time they wanted to give it like an X rating, like a you know, whatever it was,
NC-17 or whatever. Yeah.
Because it was like so filthy, and it's like now it's like you're pushing like stupid agendas and shit. Like you're so like, give me a fucking break.
Jay and Silent Bob, I love those movies.
Yeah.
But he was high for those, but I loved them.
Critical Orc Theory for $5. To be fair, Anna, most hobbits don't think about the atrocities at the two towers of Isengard and Mordor. That's true. Those are the two towers.
Are her two towers? So yeah. Those are her two towers, Isengard or Mordor. That makes me laugh. That's what I'm going to tell Anna. We need to tweet her that. Anna's two towers. Mine are the North and South Tower.
Maybe they actually, maybe there were, maybe those attacks did happen in November. Maybe we are. We're wrong.
Oh, what if that was it? What if in the storyline those happened in November? That would be hilarious.
I wonder if this whole time she thinks the Twin Towers are from the fucking
Mordor and Isengard.
Is she aware that there were Twin Towers in New York? Nice one, Critical Orc Theory. Vic for $1.99. You're not affiliated with those racists, right, Cecil? Oh, Comicsgate? Yeah. Well, that's the other thing. They're just like, if you criticize Marvel or DC, they're just like, you're white supremacist, you're racist. Meanwhile, there's like every color, every, you know, there's gay guys here. There's like, there's trans people over here. It's like, but they just are like, blanket statement, you're a white supremacist. That's it. You're a Nazi. You didn't like gay trans spider girl in a wheelchair, which is real, which
there's
is not
gay
even
gay trans spider girl in a wheelchair.
Yes, and it's like, no, it's like
not, there's not a spider wheelchair. There is not a spider wheelchair person. How does that make sense? How do they land on the wheelchair?
They shoot fucking. They shoot webs out of like arm crutches.
No,
dude, I shit you fucking not. I shit you not. She's not trans. She's lesbian, crippled.
I'm looking up right now. Wheelchair Spider-Man. What? Spider-Woman.
Yeah, and it's like, and then they're like, oh, if you don't like this.
Oh, wow, you're not kidding. Holy cow, she's got a freaking wheelchair right there. Wait, wow. She's strapped with me.
Is she wearing a pride dress too? In that?
That's wild. So when she gets out of the wheelchair, she's Spider.
Yeah, but her legs still don't work. She just uses her arms.
My gosh. So the other time, even though she's a Spider Woman, even though she can move when she wanted all day long with her webs, she chooses to sit in the wheelchair when she's not spidering? Yeah.
And you notice she's wearing a pride dress there, right? Like,
dude, this is not okay. Dude.
And they wonder, and you're like, oh, Marvel and DC, you know, you're Comicsgate if you don't like this shit. And they've been doing this shit for fucking, I don't know, 6, 7, 8 years. It's been like, it's just unreadable shit that nobody wants. And if you don't like it.
She talks about having like chronic fatigue and pain. How can Spider-Woman or Spider-Man have chronic fatigue or pain? That's the whole point of having the spider superpowers, is that you don't have fatigue, you don't have pain. Like, what?
It's relatable. You're not thinking about that one lesbian girl in a wheelchair out there who needs a hero, because she can't identify with Spider-Man. She needs Spider-Man to be crippled and
dead. She needs a whole comic book dedicated to her. It's like trans, you know, it's such a small... Oh, Vinny's mom, $20. Look at her. She loves it. She's one of my biggest supporters. Okay, with that, I gotta go.
Alex, it's been a pleasure. Always good to see you.
Vinny's mom's the best. Make sure, guys, you guys want to support me, all 1,100 of you guys, maybe go in the description and go... You don't have to subscribe. I'd love it if you subscribe. Maybe go make a comment.
You have to subscribe. Don't listen to him. You have to subscribe. Go click on it. Subscribe. He's got good shows 3 times a week. He's putting out a lot of content.
And Cecil's coming on. And Cecil and I are going to create some really good content soon. So, listen, I love you all. I just don't feel good. I'm about to take the NyQuil and go to bed. I've been coughing. I'm sick. I play through the flu for you, Cecil, because you're my friend. And I really appreciate all the help you've done. Go drink some me. Peace. Yeah.
He's got toxoplasmosis from his cats. The great Alex Stein, everyone. Yeah, give his channel a sub. Zaid Comics, what's up, Phil? Yo, Cecil, see you soon, bud. If I could get a shout out, our comic, The Lost Pages 3, we just broke 300 backers. Thanks, everyone. P.S. Cats are gay. Yeah, everybody go check out Lost Pages 3. It's on Indiegogo now. As Phil just said, broke 300 backers. Always go with the Zaid brothers. They put out a good content and good comics. So give them a back. Comics Gate to the Core, and they're fulfilling Cash Grab. I will be out and seeing them in a few days. We're waiting on the shipment to arrive. I think it'll be here in a day or two at Phil's warehouse. So then I got to go out there and sign. So I'll be out there in a couple days. All right, everybody, Lost Pages 3 on Indiegogo. Check it out. If any mod wants to throw the link in there, I'd much appreciate it. I have a clicking in my ear. Yeah, hail the motherfucking chat. That's right, Biggins. I will be out in Dallas some point in the next few, I don't know. I got a lot of traveling this year. Going to a lot of conventions. Going to Tampa, Matsuri, Jersey. Going to be in Garden City with Ethan and Billy and Graham and a bunch of guys. We went last year. Good time. Cecil is love. I'm here for Alex. Oh, look who just showed up. Welcome. Ethan Van Sciver. You just wake up?
No, I was working and I was watching your show.
What'd you think?
I thought it was real good, man.
Oh, thank you.
I think you should do a Wednesdays with Cecil too. That's how much I like Tuesdays with Cecil. Wednesdays.
You mean give it a spinoff show, but it's still just me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My own spinoff.
Yeah, and Alex Stein was really good, man.
Yeah, Alex is a good guy. So yeah, his show is going good, but I can't really discuss it, but he's got some interesting stuff coming up. But I'm going to probably be out in Dallas, go by the Blaze Studios. I know you got a big show coming up on Friday, right?
Yeah, I got two. I'm doing Pop Culture Crisis Thursday. And then I'm going to go do a TimCast IRL or whatever that is.
Now, you're going down there because he doesn't do – you have to go to the studio, right?
Yeah, yeah. So while I'm there, I'm flying out tomorrow night. While I'm there, I'm going to do Pop Culture Crisis, which is probably more my speed. I got to try to talk about Comicsgate in the midst of Trump getting arrested. You know what I mean? It's not going to be on TimCast. It's going to be
I still don't know if that's going to happen. I feel like the floodgates are going to open if they like it's the unintended consequences for the Democrats is every prosecutor, every Republican prosecutor is now got free rein to hit them with every fucking little infraction that they do. And these motherfuckers are dirty. And if you're going to go after a president for what, paying off a fucking hooker or whatever the hell it was, like something like so inconsequential. So like, if you're going to fucking perp walk a president, like, all right, motherfuckers, like
it's on. Well, I mean, that's the end of our republic. Oh, our democracy. Oh, our prized democracy. Fuck y'all. Do that. Go take a picture. Go take a mugshot of a former president, you assholes. And then we'll see about our democracy.
No, I don't mind if you get a former president who's doing something that's like fucking insane, like selling secrets to China. But if you're talking about 6 years ago, he had sex with a porn star and gave her money not to talk about
it. That's what it is.
And you're like, I'm going to prosecute in New York City as a felony. And as I said, this same fucking DA has knocked armed robbery in Manhattan is now a misdemeanor.
This is disgustingly political. Let me ask you something, Cecil.
Yes.
If Trump really, if these people really believe Trump lost the election, what is all this about?
Yeah, they would be like, oh my God, they'd be like,
bring him. Let's go. Let's do it again. We beat him by 7 million votes last time. Let's do it again.
Exactly. Their actions betray their fucking, you know, their thoughts. It's they know they can't do the same tricks they did last time. If they thought, they say, oh, Biden's doing great and he beat, yeah, if anything, they'd be like, get Trump in there again so we could trounce him again. Yeah. They would not be pulling this shit. So, yeah, of course they know it was a fucking rigged election. Come on. Give me a break. The guy was fucking, when he did do a speech, he couldn't fill a fucking, you know, he couldn't fill a barn. Literally, he did speeches in barns that no one showed up for. What's up, Adam Levine? And then you have fucking Trump doing like 100,000 fucking people in a stadium with spillover crowds in the thing. And it's like, this guy fucking, he couldn't fill his phone booth. He couldn't fill a phone booth, fucking Biden. And you're telling me the most popular president in the world, like in the history of this country, and he couldn't get fucking 30 people to show up for one of his speeches. Meanwhile, the guy running against him has overflow crowd. Like, it doesn't fuck. It's laughable. It's just fucking laughable. So, yeah, of course it was fucking rigged. And of course, if it wasn't rigged, they would be doing everything they could to get Trump to run again, because it would be a layup.
What are they going to do about, are they going to really let what's his face run again? Are they going to let Biden run for president again? I mean, what are they going to do? Are they nuts?
That's up to Jill.
That's up to Jill. Who else do they have? Who, Kamala? No.
I mean,
they have nobody.
They're gonna try Gavin Newsom, which to me is insane. He destroyed the beautiful state of California, made it an unfucking livable shithole. And I'm saying that from fucking New York, which is an unlivable shithole.
Unreal.
I can't wait to get the fuck out of here. I'm going to Florida. Death Curse $1.99. She's got 8 legs and none of them work. Yes, Spider.
I saw that.
Yeah. He was actually shocked. He's like, no, that's not true. That's not real. Like, people, when they fucking see how far fucking the agenda goes on this shit, it's like, that can't be real. But I noticed something, like somebody put something up on Instagram the other day, and it's like, when I'm watching a new Netflix show and they just introduced the black character and he's a non-binary, you know, whatever, fucking rattles off a bunch of fucking, and he's like, I'm out. Mm-hmm. Right now, this was just like a normie, like a black dude fucking just doing a short video. He's like, they just introduced this character. It's a, you know, trans, non-binary, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, okay, I'm out. One episode in. And the whole fucking chat was just millions of like normies going, I can't watch this shit anymore. It's always every show. So it's sinking into, like, you know, the general public, not just people who keep an eye on it, you know, like our side of the internet, which has been watching this shit and documenting it for fucking years. Everybody's noticing it. Like, everybody. And it's why no one's watching Disney Plus is fucking falling apart. They can't get people to watch fucking Mandalorian. They're like, people know that they fired the
Mandalorian's views down 50%, Cecil. And it's the number one. It's the number one Disney show. Views are down from last season by 50%.
People say it's because of, you know, Gina Carano getting fired, because of their pushing woke agenda. But I know it's because of a hate campaign against the Chilean actor lead, led by a right-wing psychopath known as Ethan Van Sciver, who has a grudge against the Chilean people. And it's really... Java the Creator says, fuck you, Cecil. William Wallace sympathizer. Yeah. It is kind of funny when you see, like, the people from the country that hate... See, Java's a Brit also. He was not rooting for fucking Mel Gibson in Braveheart.
I'm rooting for him in life.
Yeah. You know. I like his best work is at traffic stops.
Yeah.
He brought the term sugar tits into our lexicon, which I like.
God bless that man. Saint Mel.
He called the cop sugar tits. That's fucking great. He had a little bit of a meltdown. Christopher Nicholson for $10. Holy shit. Thank you very much. Says, I know EVS knows about this. I think Dragon Con would be right up your alley. even if it's too extreme for EVS. Please tell EVS to unban me. And unban this man. Mr. Van Skyver, unban this man.
Nope, he's double banned.
That was my Reagan. Thought I was. No. Mr. Van Skyver, unban this man.
Mm.
No?
No.
Sorry, Chris.
He tried.
I even went for his weakness, which was Reagan.
Mm-hmm.
But I just do a shitty Reagan. God damn it. That's on me, Chris. Let me see what else we got here. Yes, he did. Michael Obama. Hold on. Hail, boys. What's up, Lombardi? Hail.
Yeah, they're saying Michelle Obama could be it.
Yeah, they would just cheer that in. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, hey, that's true. Orishima Ataru, although they might be fucking, that would be up to them. I think they're kind of happy being just celebrated celebrities of like, would you want to go back into the fucking White House? Like,
no, I mean, people are saying that maybe she'll come back and say like, oh, I'm doing it for America, like out of a sense of duty for America. Do you really think the Obamas
have a sense patriots? Of duty?
Yeah. They're not patriots like that.
I mean, she's going to do the math and realize like they got legacy wealth. You know, their name is, you know, their legacy wealth for this fucking country. Like she's not going to need, even if she's like, oh, we can make a few hundred million, you know, grifting and doing fucking deal. It's like, and be what, you know, they're in their what? How old are they now? In their 60s? Like life's too short. Like fucking they're living like celebrities now. Like they are fucking top tier celebrities living the fucking life, treated like literally like royals. Why the fuck would you go? So she might, because, you know, I guess greed is a big thing, but and power, I guess, but I know I sure as shit wouldn't. Like if I just did a politician run and I'm like, now I'm literally being treated like royalty wherever I go and have unlimited money, I'm not fucking going back to work.
Of course not.
They don't have to, like, why would you go back to work? Orishima Ataru, Chile doesn't have the guts to keep this war going.
That's apparent. I mean, I haven't seen them. A trickle of, you know, recipes.
I think they've been humbled by the Mandalorian ratings.
I think so too.
I think they realized they lost this war.
Mm-hmm.
You won. You won. You single-handedly cut the ratings in half with your attack on him. When you called him a coward, a lot of people were about to tune in, and they're like, that's right, this motherfucker didn't stand up for Gina. We're not watching.
And he's fat, very fat. That's the main thing. The Chileans didn't care so much about the coward part. It was the fat part. You know, it was like flabby coward. They didn't like that.
No. Jasper Plan 9 says, nice to see you on your own channel, Cecil. Here's some money for entertaining me on everyone else's channel. Oh, thank you for $9.99. Very generous. I will be here every Tuesday until I'm not. How long you give it?
Like another, this is it, actually, probably.
Now you do have an inside track on my work ethic, so I think you might be on. I'm actually surprised I'm here two in a row.
Yeah.
Let's see. Orishima Ataru for $2. EVS should publish a recipe book with what they sent.
For who?
For the Chilean recipes.
Oh, yeah. I know that, but I'm like, who would... The fuck? Have you, like, looked at the recipes? They're not good, dude.
What? Yeah. Quick, pop quiz. What's your favorite Chilean meal?
See?
You know, Chinese food? Yeah. Japanese food? Yeah.
Yeah.
Italian food, sure.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
French food, yeah.
Yeah.
Chilean? Anyone? Nope.
I can't think of anything.
Mexican? Fuck yeah. Chilean? No. Not even in top 20 of meals. I couldn't think of it. I mean, probably better than British food, to be honest.
Well, yeah. British food's pretty boring, but it's a lot of meat and potatoes, a lot of beans. you know, a lot of stuff like that. A lot of heavy stews.
An eel pie. A lot of guts. All
pies. Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Eel pie, tripe, blood pudding.
I didn't eat very well. Germany was great. I love Germany. That was fantastic. For some reason, I felt right at home. Absolutely loved it. Italy, too.
Wiener schnitzel?
Yeah, you get that. Yeah, of course.
And then you get the bratwurst and the sausage.
Bratwurst right on the street. You know, it's like that's what they serve.
The mustard. Oh, man, that's good shit.
Yeah.
Even like Spanish and Portuguese food, like all that seafood, the paellas and the fucking, that shit's good. The sausages they make down there, it's like Chile? Not really.
Not so much. Yeah.
They're just sending you basically they were sending you useless recipes.
Yeah. I'm not using that. I'm not eating any of that stuff.
Pete Callen, E, you look like Jesse Ventura's body double in Predator.
Thanks.
I'm a sexual Tyrannosaurus. Yeah, you kind of do have a Jesse the body thing going. Well, Jesse at least. How's it diet? You go to the gym today?
Mm-hmm. Every day.
Russell Hull says, I'm pretty sure ceviche is Chilean. If it is, good for them. That's good. I like ceviche. You know, they cook it in lemon juice. You ever have that?
Mm-mm.
You put fish and like octopus and other things in, and you just put it in. You don't ever cook it. You just put it in lemon juice, and the acid in the lemon juice will cook the fish.
Right.
It's pretty good. I don't know if I want to give them the credit for that without some research. Russell, could you look that up for me? Thank you, Russell. Orishima Ataro, Chilean sea bass. His real name is the Patagonian toothfish.
Is that true?
Yeah, I guess Chilean sea bass. Yeah, that's something. I like Chilean sea bass. Does sound better than Patagonian toothfish. Yeah. Raw Chilean hamster pies. Wait, is that the shit? Because in New York, they had this people they were cooking on the street, and it had all everybody thought it was rats. Well, look at this guy. Is that during like your? That looks like a Mormon ceremony of some kind.
Yeah. I was probably like 8 years old, maybe older than that. No, I gotta be 12.
12 is what I'm.
Yeah.
What was the ceremony?
Church.
Is that a robe on you?
I think it's just a white sweater. I think it's Easter. It's probably Easter. I look very happy. Like a picture of cheer.
Precious memories. They must have caught you in between smiles.
The hood is down. Somebody said, yes. The hood is down.
Paella is Spanish. Yeah, paella. Yeah, I like. I've been to Spain a bunch. I like Spanish and Portuguese food. I like seafood though. Good stuff. All right, Chileans got, you know, Chilean sea bass and possibly, what was the other thing, ceviche.
Yeah. I don't think I've ever had Chilean food, to be honest with you.
You've probably had ceviche, probably.
I don't know.
You like seafood.
I love seafood, yeah.
Oh, no, ceviche is from Peru.
Oh, never... The Peruvians are great.
They're people. The lemon juice cures it, yeah. The acid cooks it, yep. So it's weird because you kind of like... Yeah, you get it at Mexican restaurants, usually have ceviche. It's octopus. I love octopus.
Oh, me too.
I feel bad because they're like so smart. They're like hyper intelligent creatures. You ever see them like on a
when they're a not fish that goes? Smart? You know?
No, they
they're
really
smarter
are.
Than us.
Well,
I could outsmart an octopus. It's not that big a deal.
You think so?
Yeah.
I got $20 on the octopus.
Really?
Yeah, it depends what it is. Like if you're
Trivial Pursuit.
What about escaping a fishbowl?
Yeah.
All right. People are saying it is Peru. Okay. Yeah, it is popular in Mexican restaurants, ceviche. It's good shit. Next time, get it. You'll love it.
All right. Okay.
Robert Jackson says, does Cecil have hideous eyes? He never shows his eyes.
Yep.
Yes. Ethan, you can feel that one.
Yeah, he does. Cecil's a very unpleasant looking person when he's fully when you can actually see his face completely. So
it's better in bits and pieces.
Yeah, just take a little bit of it at a time. Take a long second to get used to it because when it hits you all at once, shit.
It's kind of like a burn victim. You kind of don't want to stare, but I see them staring.
Mm-hmm.
Chilean sea bass is way too oily. Just like, what's his name? The Mandalorian when he takes off his helmet.
Just like Smiller.
Arashima Ataru. It was guinea pigs. Yeah. They were. So what was that? What country eats the guinea pigs? Is that Peru also? I think Peruvians, that's like a staple, guinea pigs. So on the streets of Manhattan, I guess they just had all these. It just looks like rats on skewers, but it's guinea pigs.
Hmm.
So
they'll eat anything over there for real.
I mean, I wonder how it tastes. Like they really dig the guinea pigs.
Yeah, I mean, not everything's edible. Just
everything actually is edible.
No, but it's not good though. It's not palatable, I should say. And it shouldn't be. Don't.
I would say Chinese food in China is to me like hell on earth. Literally it's like scorpions on a stick. It's a frog that's just bashed flat with a hammer on a stick. Yeah. It's pretty insane. Actually, there's a few places in New York I've gone to legit, Chinese from China cuisine with Chinese people. And it's not General Tso's. It's not fucking,
it's not delicious. It's not yummy like it is here.
It's they brought the first thing when I knew this shit was hardcore, they brought out a big bowl of fried chicken feet as the appetizer.
Oh, for God's sake.
Yeah, it was like eating. I ate everything, but didn't really like it. It was kind of like eating Klingon food.
Mm.
And they always they make the captains have a meal with them, and the meal is still moving in the plate and shit.
Yeah.
It's very much like that. Like it's fucking insane. Like the stuff's still alive sometimes. It's fucking weird. But
See Andrea and Lonnie Anderson together?
I do.
All right, hold on a second here. I do too. Isn't that great? Aw.
Oh, look at that. Is Lonnie Anderson still alive?
Yeah. There she is.
Where was this?
It was in Hollywood. At one of those autograph conventions that I always drag everybody to.
Huh.
It's nice, right?
There's an autograph convention in New York this weekend, but it's mostly basketball players and porn stars.
Oh, I didn't know. I'm waiting for Chiller Theater. You got to come to Chiller Theater. You got the Sopranos kids.
Okay. Is that the one we went to last time? Or that was Monster Mania?
Yeah, Chiller Theater's up in, I think it's in Secaucus.
Ah, it's near me.
Yeah, so I'll meet you there.
Okay. Yeah, I'll go. Are you going to go back? Are you going back to Monster Mania or not, really?
That was last week, and it was all what's that Hell's Angels show, Sons of Anarchy?
Okay,
it's not really my thing,
Biggin says sea bass is just a type of cod. Relax. He's a South American connoisseur. He goes down there all the time.
Really?
Yeah. He likes the cuisine. We send him pictures of the meals. Russell Hall says, nope, Peru claims ceviche. Yeah. Thank you, Russell, for checking. What was I just saying? Oh, the Garden State Comic Con we got coming up.
Yeah, I'm going to that. Hopefully you are too.
I'll definitely be there.
Cause I'm working it. I'm actually gonna have a booth. You know, I'm gonna treat it like it's a convention. It is a convention, but I mean, I'm gonna treat it like I'm working there.
Oh, and I'll distract you. I'll make you fuck around and not treat it like a convention.
Sounds good.
Is anybody protesting that you're there?
No, because I'm not officially on the guest list. So, but I will be like 3 days before. I'll pop on there.
They already know you're coming. You're all.
Oh
set.
Yeah. They got a table for me.
Are you gonna be sitting with the boys?
Yeah. I'm supposed to be sitting. I'm supposed to be sitting near them.
Who's gonna be there? Graham, Billy, the whole.
Yeah, Graham, Billy, Frege is going.
Oh, cool.
Which is like awesome.
All right. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. That was fun last year.
Yeah. Here's me and Matthew T. Martin of Snowman fame.
I know Matt Martin. How's he been? Where's he been? Oh, he's doing video game stuff, right?
No, Matt Martin's working on Snowman right now.
Who am I thinking of? Oh, Trent.
Trent, yeah. Trent's book's done and out. Al Campbell says, EVS, you sit near everyone. You understand? When you sit around the house.
Yeah, that reminds me of Honeymooners. I had a choice of a lot of girls, Alice. When I would go to beach, all the women would sit around me. Yeah, because they wanted some shade. You know, Alice, you're a sucker. If you saw a dollar on the bill, you would bend way over to pick it up. I wouldn't. You couldn't.
I love the Honeymooners.
That show is the best. Let's see. It's so funny, like how like I don't know how many hundreds, probably thousands of fucking shows are just literally redos of Honeymoon or fucking
the Flintstones.
The entire Flintstone. But there's always you could watch any. The only one that didn't do it was Seinfeld. Like, but every other fucking show, it'd be like, oh, this is the
Married with Children. Yeah, you know, it's all. Yeah,
this was the Chef of the Future episode. This is the fucking, you know, this is the he gets into a fight episode. It's like they just would lift. They would do everybody would do a Honeymooners episode.
Can it core a apple? Yes, it can core a apple.
Humna, 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 humna. Watch me do it the old fashioned way. There, I am done.
did you get the complete Honeymooners, the Lost Honeymooners set that came out? On a DVD?
No. I don't
know if it's on Blu-ray. All of the old, like, improvised episodes are on there. It's Cecil. It's a treasure trove. If all you've ever seen are the 55 episodes or whatever.
I've seen a couple of the lost episodes, but only when it played on TV. They're like, we're playing, you know, I never had it.
Oh, it's so good. I watched it. So
they would announce, like, on Channel 11 in New York, they'd be like, the lost episodes are going to be playing this week. I'd watch all that shit.
They don't have that. I mean, the next generation, I think we were the last generation that really saw those in rerun because they don't play that. Like, kids don't come home from school, snap on the TV, watch Gilligan's Island and shit. Like, that's not on anymore. That's just our experience.
Like, people are like, oh, you must be from, you know, you must be been born in the 50s. Because no, man, New York City just ran all reruns of every fucking show all the time. Like, you could watch. Yeah. And it was like, we would watch. So that's why I have, like, this crazy TV knowledge of, like, Bonanza and fucking Hawaii 5-0, the original, all of that stuff. I wasn't around when that shit was being aired the first time, but I fucking watched all of it. Like, I've watched the entire shit. I've watched Bonanza probably like 10 times over. I love that.
Little House on the Prairie.
I watched Gunsmoke, Little House on the Prairie. I would watch, what's the other one? Fucking Have Gun Will Travel. They would play like Westerns and they would play them in the middle of the night. Like Honeymooners was on at 11:30 every night. I fucking watched every night. They had Gilligan, they had I Dream a Genie, they had Bewitched. And then for some reason, they would throw Small Wonder in there, like in the middle of it. It didn't make sense. It bothered me.
Yeah. That wasn't a good show. I mean,
no.
Objectively speaking, like Small Wonder was not a quality program.
It was shit.
Mm.
It was kind of in the vein of Charles in Charge, but Charles in Charge was superior.
Well, it had that had like a Happy Days alumnus. Yeah. Like, what did Small Wonder have? Like, it was just shit.
It had Vicky, the robot.
Yeah, who was a little girl. You know, ideally, if you're going to have like a robot, you want her to be a hot maid who's of age so that you can fantasize about fucking a robot.
Like Rosie from the Jetsons.
Well,
I have a type. I'm like Schwarzenegger. I always wanted to fuck Rosie.
Yeah. I would say like the young lady who is a robot from the Duran Duran Electric Barbarella video.
That had a huge impact on you, that video.
It sure did. I really...
It's your go-to turn on.
Yeah, I wasn't into sex dolls at all. Like, I mean, I couldn't relate to a fellow like, what's his name? Your friend with the sex
doll. J. Hefner.
Yeah, like I wouldn't be able to relate to him at all on any level except for Electric Barbarella, and I kind of get it. But on the other hand, like that's an actual woman pretending to be a doll, not a doll pretending to be a woman, you know. So
now I remember seeing the movie Barbarella as a like a young kid, and I remember being very, very interested in that movie. Like I was it was a very sexy movie.
What about Weird Science? They're saying in the chat that was another one where two boys get together. You make a woman who's like servile and like submissive.
But they never fucked her.
They didn't?
No.
Off camera?
I don't think so.
That would be the entire point.
I know. No, she taught them, and then they got the two other girls from the school. The bullies' girlfriends came over to them or something.
Oh, she taught them how to love a woman. And
yeah, but they never actually fucked her. She just elevated their status by everybody thinking they were fucking her.
That'll work.
Yeah. Still, if you're going to fucking take the time to create a woman.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck her.
The Patty Duke show, those girls were underage, right?
There was just one girl.
Well, I know, but on the Patty Duke show, they were identical cousins.
I think they were high schoolers, yeah.
They're high schoolers. Sure. Okay, good.
Do I want to follow up the question? Okay. Why do you ask? And why is it all good?
Because, well, I'm just saying, like, I met Patty Duke, you know, right before she died, of course. I have a nice picture of me with my arm around Patty Duke, and there's a dark shadow cast on the wall behind her. And, yeah, I just said, I'll tell you something. I think I beat off to you when I was in high school. I beat off to the idea of a threesome with you and you, I guess. And she was happy to hear it, I think.
Now, she had a kid with Gomez Adams.
Sean Astin from Lord of the Rings. Yeah.
The best hobbit of them all. He carried Frodo's fucking ass up the mountain.
He's a real friend. He's a real friend. I would do that for you, Cecil.
Well, I would say I would do it for you. But I couldn't do it for you.
To be fair, you're right.
But
I could do it for you, and it's because you're only about 4 feet tall, and that's
I'm staying true to the fucking movie.
Oh right, yeah, of course. Yeah.
My actual hobbit.
Yes.
Pete Callan says I've never eaten out of a dumpster either. All right, Chris Topher, thank you, Chris. Thank you, Pete.
Oh, he's talking about Chilean food. Like he's never eaten Chilean food.
I got it.
Or he hasn't eaten out of no dumpster.
There's got to be one Chilean in our chat that's, you know, we got 1,200 people watching on the nose. One of them's got to be Chilean and fuming right now. Please sound up if you are. Chris Topher, Chile's famous for their sword-wielding semen swallowers. Jesus Christ.
Is that true? Going in. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I had no, I'm learning so much about Chile. It's a country I didn't really know the history. It's got a rich history. Russell Hall, I'm looking up Chilean cuisine. It looks pretty dope. All right, maybe it is good. The truth is, I don't know any of it. So, like, maybe it's good. Mm. Maybe you can. Cecil likes to eat dog dicks on a stick. That seems like a fucking...
How are they prepared?
If they're deep fried, I'll fucking give it a bite.
How would you know? If somebody gave it... Yeah, it was like, this is a nice sausage from Chile, and it's secretly a dog penis, but it's deep fried. How would you know?
Yeah, it really is. It's post-apocalyptic food. Yeah, China's like... When you know that they had that wet market and stuff, like you take a look at the video of what people are eating there, and it's like it is post-apocalyptic food. It's like
it's a bat screaming in a bowl of soup, like rah! Like you don't want to cook it or take its head off or anything like that. No, it's just got its fangs out and shit.
Yeah, they're suffering add flavor.
Yeah,
they're big into like the suffering adding flavor. You could eat a fish alive. There's one fish that they have like. Where they deep fry it, but they don't deep fry the head. And the whole time it's like on the plate and you're just picking off pieces of it. And
I'm not doing that. Look, I'm not doing it. Not participating.
The suffering is delicious. Hold on a second. There's no meat in. Well, here's the thing about chicken feet that I kind of pointed out to the table. I'm like, it's not that they might taste good, right? Except a chicken's life is literally standing in its own shit all day long. Like its whole life, it's been walking on shit because it's in these little cages that it's shitting all day in. And it's just waiting in its own shit. And now you're chopping it off and putting it in a bowl for me. Mm-hmm.
So no thank you. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. And it's still got the little nails and claws on it and everything. It's like,
yeah.
I don't know. I just
come with you. I agree.
It's just in. And you know what all it tastes like is like the Chinese cooking oil. I did take a bite, but I didn't. All the foreign food in U.S. is actually American. Yeah, pretty much. Especially Chinese. They really Americanized it. But yeah, if you go to a legit Chinese restaurant, which you can do in like Flushing, which is the home of which is where I think Comic Book Hut is from. Oh no,
that's right. Yeah, you're right about that.
He's
Patriot Hut now. Patriot Hut.
Have you watched anything? He said
he did a video. I haven't watched it yet, but he did do a video condemning Ron DeSantis for his comments on Trump.
Ethan won't leave Jersey, said he might. He's got kids gotta finish school though. Can't rip them out.
But oh, you mean leave for good? I was talking to Andrew about this just. I said, this is my home. I just came back here. I'm not leaving. I don't want to leave. I mean, I might, but I'm just saying I don't want to. I'm not anxious to leave New Jersey. The whole place makes sense to me, except for the politics.
I mean, people are leaving California, and that's literally like one of the most beautiful states there is. But people are just like, fuck that. Like even Joe Rogan, who's got basically fuck you money times 10, is like, I'm giving away more than half of my fucking salary to this fucking state that fucking hates it. It's like, fuck it. Go to Texas. You know what I mean? Like at some point, it's not paradise isn't worth it. You guys have made it, and I mean, I think in the last 2 years, like almost 500,000 people have left, and those are the producers. Like that's who's leaving, you know, because
I love going to California. I love visiting. It's so it really is just beautiful. I remember going to Jeff John's house, and just seeing like this is how you live. Like this is amazing. You know, he's like, yeah, this house used to belong to Doogie Howser. It's mine now. Swimming pool and everything. Oh, damn, like right near the Hollywood sign. And
he's up like, the hill, huh?
What's that?
He's in the hills.
Yeah, 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 he was. And then he just bought Patrick Swayze's old house. So it's just like, shit, man. It really does seem nice. Seems like there are a lot of opportunities out there. But yeah, I guess everybody's leaving.
People are leaving because it's just like, it's hot. I saw the guy from Shark Tank was on. This clip's been going around. He was on like the Don Lemon show, and he was talking about investing. And he's just like, when people come with investments, he's like, there are literally no go zones for me. He's like, I will not invest in any business in California, New York, Massachusetts. He's just rattling off like all of like fucking Illinois. He's like, you're handicapping yourself. You're starting your competition. If they're in another state, is making X amount percent ahead of you right off the bat because you're just fucking the regulations, the taxes, and then make it. Yeah, people are just even people that are rich, like Joe Rogan's like what $500 million. They just like it ain't worth it. Like it's not worth it. I think Mark Wahlberg just moved out to Vegas to Nevada somewhere. Like
I gotta say, if I had $500 million, I wouldn't care about the taxes. I'd live where I wanted to live. It's a little bit nutty to have $500 million and be like the taxes are too high here. I mean,
yeah, but you're working your ass off and it's just going, you see them the way they're shitting it away. It does eat at you when you see like just the waste and you're just like, you're like, fuck it. You know, at some point they make paradise unlivable. Like that's it. That's what I'm saying. Like,
yeah, I guess. I don't know.
You know what I mean? Like that guy busted his ass for fucking ever. You know, he's one of those guys who's always had like three jobs. He was doing Fear Factor and fucking fight announcing and stand up comedy and fucking podcasts, like hustle, hustle, hustle. And they're like, oh, here's my cut. You could have, you could have maybe 40% of what you made last year.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, what am I doing? Like, that guy's fucking hustling nonstop, get it? And it's like, he's allowed to keep less than half of what the fuck he made because they need to fucking burn it up on waste and fucking corruption.
And emasculating little children.
Right, right. And you couldn't right. even, like, you can't send your kids to school there. It's fucking absolutely insane. Torvaldsen says Japanese food got better after Enola Gay paid them a visit and showed them how to cook. Golly. Mr. Big and Ethan's gonna pack and wear body armor. Oh, for fucking for the Jersey Con? Nah, I think he'll be all right there. Unless Howard Chaykin sees him. Who's gonna be? Did you know who else is on the guest list?
Mark Brooks wanted to go, and I said he's not allowed to come. If I'm coming, he's not coming, and that was true. They denied him access.
Is that true?
Mm-hmm.
That would be funny. Would you really stop him from coming?
Not encourage him to come. It'd be great. It'd be great to see Mark Brooks face to face.
Is he coming?
No.
What about, let's see, who else would be there?
Well, look up the show, Garden State Comic Fest, and see who's on the guest list. We'll see who's there.
Is Tom King there?
I highly doubt it. I think those guys really go to the main shows. WonderCon, maybe MegaCon.
New York.
San Diego, New York, you know.
Okay. Morristown. Featured creators: Dave Ryan, Howard Chaykin, Walt Simonson, Louise Simonson, Greg Hildebrandt. How come Billy's not on there?
He should be. I saw him announce. Pull it up. Pull up the screen.
All right. Featured creators: Dave Ryan, Chaykin, Simonsons.
I don't know who Dave Ryan is. What does he do?
Is he new?
Howard Chaykin, I sure do know. Walt Simonson, Louise Simonson, salt of the earth, nicest people in the world. Greg Hildebrand. Well, I'll tell you, you're going to dine out on that Star Wars poster forever. What else? Is there more?
That's all guests? I have.
Here we go. No. Scroll down. Those are the featured creators. Featured guests. A bunch of voice actors, I guess.
Why don't they say where they're from? It seems like a simple thing to do.
Yeah.
Who's that?
What if you click on them? You click on them and you get...
Okay. Best known for his role as Charlie in the show Scandal. All right. Known for... Oh, he did the voices of Superman in DC movies. All right. So these are voice actors. Voice actors. I can see them. Oh, wait. Oh, no. It's not fucking Cryborg. It's the other side.
Can you imagine if it was? I would be there. All right, to go up now, is there another place, another thing that you can click to see more people? Because that has no comic skaters there at all. Oh, look at that up there. Up. What is all this? These are all the other people. Recent announcements. Kevin Altieri. Chris Umunga. I wish my last name was Umungus. Umunga. Keon Young.
Premier.
How can that be the webpage? There's nothing there. It's hardly anything. Oh, look, down. Oh, okay. Guests, all guests, creators. There we go.
Okay. Oh, I see Frege down there. Okay. Simonson, Hildebrand, Altieri, Uminga, Stuart Sager. You know who that is?
Mm-hmm.
Chrissy Zulo, Dan Frege.
Yes.
Graham Nolan, Andy Smith. Billy Tucci, the boys. Oh,
wow. Party. It's going to be great.
Jen Dersima, Tim Jacobus, Scott Hanna. They put all the commentators in one row.
I know. Is it alphabetical order? No.
No, it's not. Howard Mackey, Keith Williams, Holly G, Jim Ballant.
Well, I like Jim Ballant.
Jim Lawson, Dave Ryan, and Howard.
Scott Koblish. Do we have a problem with Scott Koblish, or am I imagining things? I'm thinking of Scott Kurtz. I don't know Scott Koblish.
This is the money row right here.
Yeah. We're all going to be sitting together.
And I'll be bothering you.
Dude, we'll be drunk the entire time, Cecil. It's going to be great.
Yeah, I know.
The guard.
I'm well aware. I'll smuggle in a bottle. I'll keister a bottle of booze. Maybe a couple bottles. Depends what you guys want to drink. Russell Hall. Some Chilean food looks awesome. Some is terrifying. Did you just wake up or are you going to bed?
I'm going to bed pretty soon. I stayed up to watch watch your show.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm going to wrap this up. I'm going to let you guys go. Hello, Rogan and Elon living big in town. Yeah, Elon Musk left California too to go to fucking the middle of Texas. You know, it's like the richest man in the world is like, fuck California. Like at some point, it's like, it's not fucking worth it. It's like, I'm leaving paradise to go literally the middle of like a desert state. I know it's not a desert state, but you know what I'm saying. It's like the fucking the landscape looks like Mars compared. California is like everything, you know, beaches and fucking forests, and it's beautiful. Yeah, they all went to be near Mr. Biggins by Austin and Tim Doyle. Urashima Ataru says, "I'm in Washington. It's sad watching a state degrade." Yeah, that was a pretty state too. Oregon too. Portland is such a fucking pit. It's so crazy, like what happened to Seattle and Portland. Like those were like in the 90s, those were like kind of like hip cities that were fucking up and coming and fun, and they're just absolute, just, you know, shitholes. Absolute shitholes. Same with fucking San Francisco. fucking awful. Yeah. I know. I see Sheila in the chat. She's defending California, I'm sure. Russell Hall says ceviche, crab pie, dried horse meat, conger eel soup, blood and onion sausage, chicken baked in mud, spicy tripe stew, intestines in toasted wheat. I like the ceviche crab pie, and I think yeah, that's about it. Yeah, fuck that shit. You were right to attack Pablo Pascal. In fact, if anything, you went easy on him. Now that I see their menu. Immortal Coil, who would win in a fight, EVS or EVH?
Who's EVH?
I don't know. This is a weird one. People fucking thank you for the super chat, but I don't know who the fuck you're talking about. Russell Hull says, for your information, chicken baked in mud is actually delicious.
Yeah. Oh, people are saying it's Eddie Van Halen.
Oh, you'd kick his ass.
He's dead. Yeah. I mean it. He's,
yeah.
That's no threat.
You could probably, at this point, you could probably pull his arms off.
I fucking body Eddie Van Halen.
You could pull his arms off and play his guitar with his arms just to mock him. I mean, not well, but still, you could do it. SHS Rebels 08 says it's never too late to change your last name to Moby Dick EVS. That seemed like.
Why is he saying that? Did I say something wrong? Did I offend anyone?
No. Before just being assholes. How about David Lee Roth?
Could you? I don't know about that. No, I don't think so. That guy. You ever see him like do the split kick in midair? He could kick both of our asses. Like we could be like Cecil, you go this way. I'll get him from the front. And then
he'll be like, I might as well jump.
And then both of us. Yeah.
I'm going to go ahead and jump and kick us both in the face.
Like, yeah.
Damn.
I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't mess with Diamond Dave.
I wouldn't beat up. I wouldn't want to beat up David Lee Roth. David Lee Roth has a katana. He was like, I think he was a karate guy or some kind of martial arts guy.
Was he really?
Yeah. There you go. He has a black belt. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of the stuff, a lot of those kicks were just basically his kickboxing and martial arts kicks that he just
kind of. Can you imagine that? I wish I were like him. Like, I wish I had like. I wish I had like, let me see, AOC coming from the front, and then who else? Smiller coming from the back, and I would just be like this, Cecil. I would just be like this, like, I mean, just
you know, balls out.
Just get them both at the same time. I couldn't think of people that I dislike.
Smiller, that'd have to be a third one in the middle who you'd rub your balls on their face as you did. Nancy Pelosi. Wait, oh, who is
it? Yeah, Nancy Pelosi.
Harry Reid, right in the center. Mm. Give him the ball drag.
I hated Harry Reid, man. Oh my god.
World's most famous Mormon.
Yeah. What a scumbag. He's in hell now.
He died?
Yeah. Thank God. I can't wait till Nancy Pelosi dies. I will laugh.
Schumer gets the balls. She'll outlive us all, man. Are you kidding me?
Mm. Oh, they said that about Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Who's laughing now?
Robo Gators Ginsburg. They put her brain into a robot. I am laughing now. Russell Hall, chicken baked in mud is... would fully blow at, you know, she would probably fucking eat that. That's good. That's a good point, Russell. She does like dirt. Chicken baked in mud. She's probably like, there's an idea. Yeah, she's a hero, actually. To the right.
Who is?
RBG.
Oh, yeah.
Her fucking hubris got us the court.
Hmm.
God bless her. It's like, what was the guy's name? Was it Bill Buckner who missed the the ground ball in the 1986 World. I wish the
bomb. Yeah, where's the hut? He would know.
Because when they would play in Shea, he'd get a standing ovation.
It's humiliating, dude. That ruins your life. You got to live with that forever. Wonderful. Oh, my God. Baseball season is in like 2 weeks.
Spring training.
Spring training now, but like season openers, April 6th for the Phillies.
Jeez, man, this year's flying by. Yeah, Russell Hill, we know you're not joking. I'm actually going to bring up that there's something called chicken baked in mudge. You probably fucking would like it. Weirdo. Faust Meth Manga Aesthetic says, Howard Chaykin is still alive. Yes. I saw him. I saw him with my own eyes.
He said he wouldn't drink with me.
I ain't drinking what you're drinking, is what he said to you. Let me get you a drink, Howard. I ain't drinking what you're drinking. Now, somebody pointed out that he's a recovering alcoholic or something, so maybe that's what he meant, but I don't think that's what he meant.
Well, I was only drinking milk, so.
He's also lactose intolerant.
Yeah.
I ain't drinking what you're drinking.
Oh, I love it.
That was fun. I really did enjoy that. Like, it was like walking into a bar with Satan.
Mm. With me? Like, I'm Satan?
Yeah, everybody like scowling at you.
We'll do it again. It's going to be fun. How did this happen? It's ridiculous.
You voted.
But I'm telling you, we live in a world where they want to arrest Donald Trump right now, and they want to put him in handcuffs. Like, seriously, it is absolutely insane. I was watching, what's his name, Dilbert guy, Scott Adams today. Go off. Scott Adams has lost his fucking mind, dude. He is like, he's trying to play cool that he was canceled. It takes a while for cancellation to sink in. At first, there's like denial or something. And then like once it starts to hit you, you get pissed. I think he's at that phase right now where he is getting pissed about it. He's like, fuck y'all. I haven't heard him say the F word so many times. You know, and he's like, and I don't, when I say y'all, I don't mean black people, but fuck you guys. Fuck, not black people. Fuck, I love black people, but fuck you guys. He keeps having to say, like, he loves black people. When he says, fuck this whole group of people. And then he goes, I don't mean black people. I just mean, you know. So,
you know what I want to talk about?
Yeah. Mexicans. But yeah, I mean, it's something else, dude. He is pissed, and he's just like, it's all real. All this stuff is real.
Yeah, well, he said recently that he knew he was going to be canceled.
Why? Why would you know you're like? I don't understand. Like, I guess he doesn't care because he's got enough money. But to me, it would seem like an unforced error. I don't think he needed to say that white people should stay away from black people, and I guess he meant it. I guess he actually like meant that. I don't know. He kind of said, well, am I wrong? I said, oh, you meant, oh, you were serious. At first, I was like that Jonah Jameson gif, you know, that meme. Oh, you're serious. Like, that's how I was.
I guess, was he serious?
Yeah.
I thought it was kind of like a.
I did too, but no, he did. Like, he didn't come back and say, I didn't mean that. He just kind of said, according to this poll and what this is saying, then yes. What am I wrong? If this poll means what it's saying, then yes. White people should get away from black people. Am I wrong? You disagree? And I'm like, holy shit.
Right. So, Tiny Baby Sloth. So when he said those people, he meant those black people.
He meant those black people.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to wrap it up here on Scott, unless you want to continue about Scott Adams for a moment. You got a thought you wanted to finish?
I have zero thoughts at all. I'm in real trouble.
Welcome to my world.
Yeah, I'm a blank slate.
Well, I appreciate you hopping on here, and I appreciate everybody. How many hours? Wow, I was going to only do 2 hours. We did like 3.5 hours. I want to thank Alex Stein and, of course, the great Ethan Van Sciver. Thank you for hopping on. And I want to thank everybody who left a super chat, left a chat, everybody in the chat, everybody for hitting like, which is like, I said, thank you. I don't know why I said that, but getting like, and we still got 1200 people here. So
people really want you to keep going.
Yeah. I got to pee and I got to go to sleep.
Not in that order.
No, no. I usually piss about 5 minutes.
You go to sleep and then you got to pee.
Yeah.
Go to sleep and pee the bed.
Thank you so much. I will be doing this next week. I appreciate everybody for making the second episode a big success. And I say good night.